the show here. I gotta come up with some lyrics.
It does sound
Speedy
like
he could never be a freestyler.
Yeah, he was always the weak link when it came to that.
Could be a rapper.
I know. I don't know what's going on.
We were just having the discussion off air about how about how people think it's just easy to just like be a stand up, or jump on radio.
Yeah.
People think that you just get on the mic. And
when I invite these niggas down here and they kill themselves.
At first, some of the fans were like, well, you know, they bombed and they were worried about it. I was like, no, we want them to do that. Yeah. Like, we get the jokes from that, or it's funny. You know what I'm saying? Hey, it is what it is.
We don't want them to do that, but if they do,
it's your win either way.
Yeah.
Especially with Vanessa here, because she's like,
Vanessa.
When you do your shake.
And then she'll do this. And then she'll be like.
Yeah, your poker face is terrible.
Now I'm starting to pinch her. Like, yo, let's
you
get
and
it together. Poetess,
poker face is the worst. P just stared at nigga like, really? Who
and then
told
some
you
will slip out of her mouth.
Yeah.
Like, you know.
I think,
I
think because comedy seems like the easiest thing to do, most people just go, I can do that shit. That's why you have a lot of brothers who see their brother do it and go, nigga, I want to get out. Because they go, that if he doing it, or like, nigga, I ain't go to school for this shit, but trust me, I got years.
I don't even think comedy is something that you have to learn. I think it has to be in you.
Yeah.
But there are some techniques to bring out your comedy better. But I think to be a comedian, that's almost a natural thing.
Sinbad said that. He said, because the white girl that's at the comedy store that teaches stand-up. She charges $300 a person. Her class is always filled.
Wow.
With at least, I think it's like 45 students all the time.
Yep.
And Sinbad's shit was, you can't teach funny.
You
either
cannot.
Got it or you don't.
I agree with
but
that.
But some people believe that.
Doesn't she have a thing coming up?
No, our own little missing piece.
Oh, that's right.
Kente.
David Arnold.
So a lot of comedians.
I knew this girl in David's class. I said, David be charging.
Yeah, he charges a lot.
She's like, I'm learning from David Arnold. I'm like, bitch, nigga, you just paying. That's all you doing. You ain't learning shit. It is your boy. It's your boy, Speed Doggy Dog, in the building. Just want to let everybody know I'm here, just in case you need to. If you have a happy birthday, ladies, let me know and I'll give you a birthday shout out.
Yeah.
Today, your birthday can't be 2 weeks. You're like, give me a shout out. No, today has to be your birthday and I'll give you a little. Yeah, me and DJ Ron to give you some love. Shout out to DJ Ron, killing before the show, man. Shit. I mean, I actually had some of those songs. Yeah.
Hilarious.
All them songs.
Well, starting Monday at 10:30, DJ Ron will be doing a set.
Oh, shit.
Nice.
Before the show. So
he's a real employee now.
You got to give him something.
Yeah, get up now, DJ Ron.
Got to give him his own.
Well, he's here like at 6:30.
But here's the thing. When I call Ron, the first thing I said, well, what you do during the day? He's like, nothing. I was like, hey, check this out. You like me, nigga. You just at home.
All of us, pretty much.
Your girl like, get on out of here. Shit, go do something. Who, Pam? Nah, stay home. That bitch.
Wow, really?
Damn.
Hey, you told a nigga you want to hit?
No, she told you. And you told the world.
Yeah, you told.
Same thing.
And poet is told, actually.
You're like that break when needed.
Wait, what?
What?
Yeah, if his girl trip out, he know you here. Hey, Pam.
Hysterical.
So she's got the girl that's going to be on her best behavior.
Yes,
she
sir.
She knows that Ron has many options.
Got options. He for sure
on
got
Monday,
one.
He got two. He got Precious.
He got two. And Precious just want to be on the bottom. So that's all on the side.
I want to comment on somebody, Bob Backwoods, in the chat room.
Mm-hmm.
420 is coming up on a Wednesday, and I did have a pre-conversation already with Ron C., that on that day, we're playing all 420 songs.
Well, I ain't gonna be here.
Somebody said, keep Speedy away from the playlist. Speedy don't know nothing.
My godson's birthday is 420. What's her name, son?
The little baby? Is it Weedhead?
No. What her mom and daddy are, actually.
So stupid.
Yeah.
So y'all like, so is it 420? Do we got to do like 420 stories? Ron, you don't smoke,
we are celebrating.
Nigga, Ron don't do shit. He don't drink.
I think me and Pam are the only 420 friendly people.
Ron don't drink.
I threw a party one year.
He don't do shit. He don't trust us. I said, you want something to eat? Ron like, no, I'm cool. All right,
nigga. Nigga don't eat, don't drink.
He ain't stole no Snickers yet.
I know, right?
I did. I just ate the Milky Way.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, now you
see. You must.
You official now.
I'm going to take pictures and show you how Speedy sabotages my diet here. Speedy got
that was
Snickers,
actually Pam.
Milky Ways, Pringles.
And here's the closest.
Cheese puffs. So I'm like, that is torture to a 420 friend.
Really, it is, because once we leave, you are here to stop you. You like, don't do it, do it. Just think about it.
Right.
I'll just do one. And then you say you're going to do one, when you look at the table, it's 9 wrappers. Like, God damn.
Oh my
Especially
God.
The little Snickers and stuff. It's like, really? You got to eat like 4 to make a whole
When
Snickers?
I got my first apartment, I was like, cool, and I bought all this shit, nigga. I don't even think I bought real food. I was buying like ice cream, cookies.
Oh my God.
Wow.
All the shit I couldn't have. And my mama, nigga, I had abundance of Oreo, like Chip Ahoy's. Ooh, nigga.
Chip Ahoy's. Yeah, I love Chip Ahoy's.
Dipped. Oh, nigga.
Dipped in what?
Dipped in what?
Milk.
Milk.
Oh,
but don't. It's about a 1 second. 2 seconds, that motherfucker break. Damn, goddamn.
Yeah, you can't
do that. Now I need a spoon. This is bullshit. But
Speedy, so you didn't have, you had sandwich food, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Nah, nigga, I was bad.
Just junk food?
Yeah. I was 19 when I moved out. 19 years old.
And that was all that was in your cupboard.
Pretty much, because I fast food. I go McDonald's, come home. And that's back in, I'm telling you how old this was.
Did you have
McDonald's had a box. Remember the box meal?
No.
Yeah.
No
kids
meal.
Came in the box, not the kids meal. Back in the day, McDonald's had a box.
Did you have that black lacquer furniture? And
yeah, I did.
I did
the swap meet.
Ooh,
I did the swap meet.
That's a turn off for me.
Smoke table.
Ooh.
With a water. I told you I had a water bed.
Hysterical.
I'm in the bed like, this is the bullshit. By myself. Not cool. And then you try to fuck on the water bed, niggas, you don't have no. She's like, you, bitch, if you shut up, I'll be in. Shut up.
Hilarious.
Fuck this water bed. Get on the floor. But yeah, when I got my first apartment, all the zoom zooms and wham whams you could eat.
What? Well, I got it. That's an old thing to say.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like, the
you had to go to jail to know about that.
Wham-wham.
Zoom zooms and wham whams. And I didn't drink that much water back then. So it was like big gulps at 7-Eleven with the clip on it. I would at least drink 2 or 3 of those a day.
Speedy, do you have diabetes?
No.
I was gonna say diabetic in waiting.
He close.
No. I'm good. I know y'all wishing these bad things. Wait a minute, did she just say something and then disappear back on the phone? What in
Where'd
the
she go?
Fuck
she
is
came
going?
In, you got diabetes, nigga.
Yeah, and then got out the way. 323-293-3375. Who else in the building?
Nikki Pam.
Vanessa Graddick.
And POTUS is somewhere.
She's on her
knees.
Just
like, how did she do that?
Dude back there?
I'm trying to.
I'm like, what happened?
I'm trying to fix my camera.
Are you sucking dick? Okay. What you doing?
Ew. God, Speedy.
Hey, it is Freaky Friday.
Really?
Jesus.
She's going underneath the table.
Yeah, I was under the table.
You were?
But no, Dicky.
As he's eating the Snickers. You sucking that? Mm-hmm. Put some of them crumbs on my dick.
Oh,
hilarious.
Oh, my God.
Gosh.
What?
But we do have a good question of the day, right?
Yes, we do. I don't know if Vanessa going to be able to chime in. She might not want to chime in because she's so Miss Goody Two-Shoes. I was never done that.
What are you talking about?
323-293-3375. Mm-hmm. Question of the day. Mm-hmm. And chat room and Hateful Eight, all y'all get involved. Have you ever had a one-night stand that turned into a relationship?
Of course.
Explain.
Let's pick one.
That's what I said. That's what I
mean. Damn. Okay, Vanessa.
Oh, Willie. Good old Willie.
What happened with Willie? How'd you meet him?
That's an old name right there.
No, Willie.
Hey, Willie here.
Willie played for the Vikings at the time.
Hysterical.
Uh-huh. He played for the Vikings. We met at a club, and then like all his team went home and he went with me. He was like, I just want to eat you out. I'm like, that's a lie. This ain't my first rodeo. I already know.
That was his first. And you in the car when he says this?
No, it's by the time we got back to the house. We had went to eat and hung out or whatever.
But yeah, you
got to
like, go okay. play it off like you yeah. don't really want it. But.
And I was like, this is going to be the end. This nigga's a Viking. We ain't going to make it. And then we were together a year or so after that.
That means y'all didn't make it.
Well, we made it for a year. Right. You said you didn't ask.
Now let me ask you this. So he hits that night. When's the next time y'all get back together? Or is he like hanging out every day after that?
No, it took... We didn't talk for another maybe 2-3 days, I think. And I was like, I knew it was going to be a one-night stand. And he hit me, was like, no, we were on the road. And and then we were good after that. After that, we damn
near lived
together.
Did you go on the road with him and stuff? Why do I sound?
I don't know. It's weird.
Yeah.
I didn't go on the road with him. I had a job. I had shit to do.
Oh,
but,
okay.
like, when he was gone or if his family came in, I would take care of them or they would stay with
me. Because most people say that, you know, the reason why most women won't do one-night stands is like, well, this, if I do the one-night stand, it ain't going to turn into shit.
Right.
And I totally disagree with that. All
sometimes
my one
you
night
don't
stands
want it to. Like if you sometimes you just want a one night stand. Mm-hmm. You just like there are niggas. So I'm like, okay, this is
so when he walked up to you, you were like, I'm
some guys got the good D, but they not all put together upstairs.
Right.
So you just might want to just
you can't get it all. You ain't gonna have a big dick and a nigga with a job. That shit
yes,
don't
you
go
can.
Together. No.
Yes, you can.
And he like
can.
You. Look, come on,
yes,
some other shit got
yes,
go with that.
You can.
And no
yes,
kids.
You can.
So you well,
you putting all
no,
these extras on it.
There's a such guy.
There mm-hmm. is.
Yeah.
Anyway. So he walks up to you, you knew right away I'm gonna fuck
you. Fucking?
His body was amazing.
Mm. Well, he's a football player.
With the clothes on?
With the clothes. I
you
can tell.
With the clothes on.
I can tell.
Speedy, do you wanna know with the clothes
on? I don't know shit. I'm just
I can
curious.
Tell.
Okay, cool.
I can tell immediately.
Did you just say that is so gay, Sky?
No, I said this is so crazy.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
Why are you trying to taint Sky?
No, I thought.
That's my little.
I have my headphones on. Anyway.
That's my wannabe daughter. Stop it.
Aww.
I love her.
She's she does hug girl. Speedy and no one else.
Right.
Like,
I care about her.
I
don't
care
know
about
why,
her.
Though.
Speak,
why
buddy?
Speedy?
Yeah.
Because I care about her. Mm. For real.
Like we don't?
I got her.
Speedy has a really good fatherly way
yeah.
about
well,
him.
Well, he has a lot of practice.
Yeah.
What?
The fuck?
You're fatherly. 15 tries.
Even sometimes he thinks I'm his child,
yeah.
and I'm like, no, no. Grown woman,
yeah,
grown
sometimes
woman.
Sometimes I'd be swag. Like, damn, what? Wait, Speedy?
Right.
I never treat y'all like that.
Yes,
you
do.
A lie.
Speedy,
you real fatherly.
I've learned more about you in these 8 months that I've known in the last 30 years that I've known you. And that's real talk.
All right.
We do spend a lot
323-293-3375.
I think we do spend more time than we've ever spent
yeah, we
together.
Yeah.
Because even when we were doing the Foxhole, that
was just
like
one week, yeah.
yeah.
And
2 hours.
And
but we were on the road together, too. Mm-hmm. And Speedy.
That was funny. Mm.
Speedy thought he was better than all of us.
I'm sure
when
he
we
did.
Were on the road.
So that's how he's
going
to act.
That's why we say Speedy's on tour. That's when he thinks he's
better than
all
of
us.
Yeah. It'll be interesting to see how he acts when this movie gets popping. Or you said you were going to New York for a week. Is that what you said or something?
So
who would be? Let's get G thing to sit in.
Hilarious,
Speedy when he's on his movie break.
All right, and when Pam goes on break, we'll call the nemesis.
Okay.
Now, motherfucker.
Pam, how would you feel about that?
I'd be pissed. Not gonna happen.
Oh, we getting the everybody's phone be blowing up. Who is it? It's Pam? She's at the gate. She's at the gate. Oh, she's
I
in Chicago.
Right, exactly.
I thought she was on vacation.
She at the gate. She said, fuck it. She climbed
no,
over.
No, that happened one time. I'll tell the story. Ananda and John Sally had a show
mm-hmm.
on the beat.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I remember that.
When Ananda called in sick one day, so they called me to come in and sit in for Ananda. When I tell you, she was up at that station.
She was
sick.
She had Ebola.
After
everything.
Calling in sick,
coughing,
didn't shower, nothing.
Really?
Came.
Hilarious.
You already behind the mic. And Ananda's here, huh?
Hey, Ananda. How are you?
I'm fine, bitch. Slide over. You're in the wrong seat. Your voice is fucked up. Who gives a fuck? Slide over.
Right.
What happened to Ananda?
I don't know. I haven't seen
I think
her
she had
in a while.
Kid. Or
did she?
I don't know. I'm making that
up. All right. So, again, we're talking about can a one-night stand turn into a relationship? You said yes because it did.
Yes, it can.
Pam?
I've always been that girl who basically I have sex with somebody, then I end up in a relationship. Mm. Now, I've had one night stands where
you got
I,
that red snapper.
You hit that couch.
You got that snapper.
I was like, lay on your couch. You're like, I'm here, bitch. I ain't
it's like you, and these niggas never leave. I'm like, really? And like,
yeah, because you got shit. Young niggas, right?
Because Pam be like, you want to move in?
Right. I'm like, no.
They be like, I'll move.
Right,
remember, she date them young niggas. As soon as they walk in, bitch, you got PlayStation and Nintendo?
Oh, God, I ain't going nowhere.
Right.
And the kitchen is stuck.
Yeah,
but then I've had the ones too where I'm like, I've had the one night stands where I'm like, yeah, I'm not even interested because the shit was so whack.
This is how you know you the shit, fellas. The one night stand, you wake up the next morning, she goes, can you drive me to work? Yeah. That means she would give you the car.
Hilarious.
Nigga, I got her car.
Who does? After a one night stand?
Nigga.
It can happen.
But you had to have that. Hey. You had to have that with me, wham.
Yeah,
maybe it's your gift of gab.
No, I got that Whimmy Wham.
Mm. What's the Whimmy Wham?
Please don't one. Make him describe it. Please, God.
There's only one way to find out about the Whimmy Wham.
Oh, my God.
You want it?
For what?
And so you do get a lot of guys that...
well, I don't know about a lot, but I've definitely... most
you
of
dick
have...
on the first name?
Really, Sweetie.
I'm asking.
Damn.
It depends on the person.
It's part of the sex.
It's Freaky Friday. I can ask.
It's part of the sex, right?
No.
I mean, are you like, you like.
But here's the thing. First date.
Did you see Ron come around?
He did.
He did like that.
Damn.
No.
At least imagine.
She's building up.
But you're not your best because you're not really sure. Like,
no.
It's,
no.
You know, you're just kind of like, I don't know if this nigga's really clean. I don't know who else been sucking. So it's like a mental thing. Like,
and now you
know
you can
I can't really get into
cancer.
I saw that yesterday on Dr. Oz, motherfucker.
Vagina.
It's, yeah, you can get sexually transmitted cancer.
HPV.
Yeah, it's cancer. Yeah, I was like, shut
HPV.
Up.
HPV.
From drinking water from somebody,
I was like,
kissing.
Damn.
I couldn't believe
you
it.
You can't even suck a dick these days.
No, that's you can get cancer.
Well, I can put a baggie on my shit now.
Won't feel the same.
Hey, let me decide that. No, I think one night stands is the shit. I just feel like it should happen all the time because
so
I need to know.
Obviously, I'm
not
sure
anymore,
you've had sex with women you've never talked to again.
Most definitely. Mm. Mm-hmm.
I've done
that. But my first night, I like try to do it all.
So mm-hmm. You don't keep their number in case you're in that town again?
Or... Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'd keep the numbers. Just as soon as I come in town, hey, I'm performing. But I throw out a net. I hit like six of them.
See,
one show up, I won.
Hilarious.
There's probably one who I just never talked to again. I ain't even care to get his number. I was like, all right.
Was the sex bad or was just?
No, it wasn't bad. It was just, okay, that was for tonight. You the tonight nigga, and I don't ever want to talk to you again.
Mm.
It was cool.
But see, unlike her, like I said, I try to do it all. Like, literally try to do everything. Like, you not going to sleep. Like, that's the night.
Are you trying to go put your best foot forward on the one
I'm trying to knock the fucking walls out.
Why? What would be the purpose? I mean,
because I need to impress you.
Oh.
So that way you'll be
so she can want you
a
second night that you're not going to give?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I need her to call and I'll be like, so when she called, I'll be like, ah, damn, tonight's not good night. Me and DJ Ron got a show to do. He coming to get me. We out. Sorry.
Really?
Boom.
Hilarious.
And then they just be calling because they be fiending for it.
Oh, God.
I don't know about fiending.
It's the Whimmy Wham.
No, there's no Whimmy Wham.
I like the way you said it.
There's no.
Yeah.
And no, I do not go all out on a first date, niggas.
She just said she don't.
I just don't know.
And, okay, how about you, P? We know you ain't fucking on the first night. Oh, you do?
I
think I can recall one night stand.
Mm-hmm.
Now, did you walk up to him or he came up to you?
No, it was somebody. It was a promoter that booked me on tour.
Hilarious. You want your money? It's in my room.
Right.
Where your money at?
I was attracted to him. Mm. We were attracted to each other. And, you know.
Was
but
it worth
I
it?
Always know that he was from, I was in Detroit. He lives in Detroit. And I just said, okay, hey, I'm a rapper. I'm on tour. Why not?
Day.
Mm-hmm. And
but did it turn into a relationship?
No, not at all. I didn't because I live in LA. I don't believe in that.
I did long distance, Seattle.
Then he
and
turned
Oakland.
Out to be because I felt like it was a one night stand. He turned out to be sort of stalkerish.
Mm. From Detroit?
Yeah.
Mm. Oh, wow.
So men can't take it when LA. Women do you the reverse.
Well, I haven't been done like that. So
I doubt it.
Ain't nobody had me with my nose open. Mm. Maybe when I was 15.
Lies. I do not lies. Believe that.
Maybe when I was 15.
Speedy, you've been in a bush or two looking for a bitch. It's written all over your face.
I've
what
never
you doing?
Done.
What you ain't
hilarious.
No,
I'll be here.
It.
I'll be waiting.
I've never done it.
Okay.
I got homies that done it, but I've never
the homies
stalked. I never like the repeated phone calls or now the whole bunch of texts and you look at your phone, it's just you. Mm-hmm. Like, oh nigga, I'm stalking. Never done it.
Hilarious.
I got that bomb shit. I got the whammy.
I've never heard anyone brag about your shit.
Yeah. Right.
Well, do you want numbers?
Yep.
Yeah, let's do that.
Have them call in.
We need proof.
Have somebody call in about the Whimmy Wham. Get somebody to call in and tell us right. about this alleged Whimmy Wham.
Whimmy Wham.
Well, we've had some guests on here that fuck Speedy, though.
Wow.
We have. Shit.
Did they admit it?
Yeah, they actually did.
Like in public?
Wait, I can't back remember up, what, Pam, what did you
have
say?
We had guests on here that fuck Speedy, right?
That one girl.
Which one was it?
The singer.
I think she was on Rollout.
She was on
Reach Around Radio.
Yeah, she was
on
that show. Singer.
I could have sworn it was a comedian in here.
Like a short Jerry curl.
And real thick. High yellow girl.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But she didn't brag on
my
it,
friend
did. She?
I forgot about
what
that.
What the fuck? She was done.
You know what?
What?
I might have to give Speedy.
Because
my friend, remember the one you said that was cray cray? Mm-hmm. The one that, in Vegas that came up on stage or whatever? Did you see her? That she came up on the stage and then Speedy like freaked out or whatever. And she was basically, you were gone. You left the room as usual. But
I'd be leaving.
Yeah.
She went to the bar.
Yeah. But anyway, so she had called me and told me about Speedy's game. And that's why, you know, I was like, really? Interesting.
Oh, so you were surprised?
I was very surprised. Because she was trying to fuck you that night. That's what she was calling you. So, you know, she was like.
She was crazy.
It was the most.
Ron is trying to signal one of y'all over there.
What am I doing?
Oh, your bra came loose.
What happened?
How Speedy wishes.
But so you never had a one-night stand lead to a relationship, is what you're saying?
No.
And Pam, you have?
I have, yeah.
You have.
For I sure. mean, yeah. but it's not a one-night stand if it leads to a relationship.
If you think
it started off that way.
Yeah,
though.
It starts off that way. And then you're like, oh, I kind of like this person.
Yeah.
323-293-3375. We want to hear about your one-night stand that turned into a relationship. Maybe you married that person.
Yeah, somebody in the chat room said they did.
Some people have married one-night stands.
Yeah.
But I don't think, a lot of women, it's mostly women. I'll say 99.9% of the time it is women.
Our dear sweet Sky.
No, that's why I didn't ask her.
She said that her children's father, rest in peace.
Mm-hmm.
One night stand. Was a one night stand. It turned into something.
Well, yeah,
it turned
kids.
Into two little bitty lemonheads.
And they're so cute. And
two little
mini-me's. And so well behaved.
Really?
And I must say, I was so impressed.
They were just
the little
so
dudes
polite.
Came in and they sat down. And they
unlike
didn't move.
Some
Speedy's kids.
Speedy's kids.
Hey, it's an asterisk by that.
Hey, an asterisk. With
wait, didn't you mess with Hope Flood?
No.
Oh, I could have swore.
No,
okay.
Jamie said, did.
Yeah.
Oh, it was Jamie. Yeah, that's right. Okay.
How did that jump in?
Well, because somebody said it in the chat room, that's who it was. So.
Oh.
No.
Pam said he fucked a comedian and they said.
I know it was a comedian that came in here and said that, but whatever. Mm. I can't remember who.
Anyway.
You going to tell us which one it was?
I can't remember. Oh,
I told you.
Lou Nell.
No, I fucked Sherry Shepherd.
Oh, that's right.
When she first got to LA.
Oh. Because
everybody thought her titties was huge. That's how I got to see how big they are.
Oh,
they look big
God.
On her. She was stone cold free.
Well, when she took her bra off, it wasn't that big.
No, because her titty sat on her chest.
It was probably her bra.
Hilarious. But stone cold free. Stone.
Damn, sweetie.
Man.
Where is she these days? She's not on the
She had a short stint on Rosewood. She was on Rosewood.
Yeah, and she's been on a lot of different things.
She's supposed to be moving back to L.A.
Oh,
she's
really?
Cool as shit, though. Sherry Shepherd is
cool. She changed just a little bit, though.
When we saw her at Foxhole Live, she was real cool.
Yeah, but
is she from Oakland?
No, she's from here.
Oh, okay.
Well, I think. I'm not for sure. But, yeah, Stone Cold Freak. Wow. Yeah.
Why that didn't work?
Oh, because he was a comic.
Oh, I
And I just needed to see what the titties look like.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Sometimes you need to know.
Well, we're going to have to invite her on the show.
Yeah,
and perhaps get the scoop.
Insight. Yeah. Why do y'all want you want somebody to talk bad about me?
Because
they're not
no,
going to do
not
it.
Bad. I just feel like you just me. Hype it up so yeah. much.
Right.
You
spend a lot of time
outside
talking about
of us right. not wanting to try it ourselves.
Yeah.
We want somebody to
the next
confirm
best thing is
now,
I want
that's
these bitches
absolutely
you
hilarious. Not wanting to try us. I don't want to test anything.
Nah, no, thanks.
It's okay.
Hey. I just need somebody to come and confirm or deny.
Well, because you hype it up.
If you
like,
had been in Vegas,
it's the
so
best
much.
D in the world.
Had you been in Vegas, my friend, like I said, had you been in the room?
But she was crazy. So she was
yeah,
already.
She was like, crazy about me.
She was stalking this nigga, like calling me, then like calling
she,
him. Calling
like she
me,
came up
him.
To the softball game drunk. And I'm sitting next to, I think I was sitting next to Nemesis.
Uh-huh.
And then she went, who is this bitch? I went, at the softball game, bitch? You drunk?
That ain't even my type.
Yeah, I'm like, Nemesis? No. And yeah, so she was.
So can we find somebody who's not batshit crazy to attest to your whimmy wham?
Well, they all crazy. So.
I'm for trying to
what
be nice.
What the fuck? You know I'm right here.
Oh, our bad. We forgot you was here.
I'm trying to give them the benefit of the doubt. Maybe there's one sane bitch who was having a rough day.
I do it. Shit.
Right.
Take one for the team.
Take one for the team.
Hilarious.
Ain't nobody ever had to take one for the team. Fuck it.
Lies. That's what you think. There was a conversation between some chicks. Like,
hilarious.
Fuck.
Speedy? Speedy?
Oh, fine, bitch. We better get IHOP after this.
Get an iPhone, maybe. Anyway. Yeah, so call in and let us know about your one night stand that turned into a relationship.
Ron.
Hey, Ron, you ever had one? Yeah.
Wait till Palm.
Of course, what? He's a DJ. After the club,
yeah,
some
he
chick.
Said no. He just said no.
I don't believe that, Ron. Come on, Ron.
One night stand.
I've never had.
Oh, okay.
Wow.
Why? Is it because, see, that's the thing is like when you have a one night stand, more than likely the woman's going to think that that's all it is.
But you
say that it's cool to give it up on the first
you should.
Day or
not. You should. If you're trying to hold it for some special occasion, then I'm fuck somebody else.
I think it's cool to give it up when you want to. If that's the first day,
right.
go for
Thank
it.
You. That's the best mm-hmm. time.
Yeah, when you want to. If that's the first day, cool. If it's 90 yeah. days from now, it's whatever
you want to
do.
Would suggest that you fuck me that day.
I would suggest not fucking you ever.
We have a call, guys. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Hey, guys. This is Simone from Ohio. How you guys doing?
Hey, Simone. What it do?
Simone Midwest.
So you had a one-night stand that turned into a relationship?
Well, I'm married, but I have had a one-night stand before. I didn't really want to talk to him anymore, so it really wasn't something I wanted to engage in anymore. I don't like that feeling of one-night stands, but it was cool, and I was single.
But was the sex good, though?
You know what? It was kind of like in my high drunk days, so I don't really remember.
This nigga thought that nigga I put it on her. Well, she don't remember.
Right.
You know, when you're under the influence, everything feels good sometimes. So,
true that.
Yeah. You
know, yeah.
Like that was
but
amazing.
I did want to ask Speedy a question.
Shoot.
Since you enjoy all your plates and all your storytelling, what made you want to get married?
Because I got to a point in my life where I got tired of just, because every single night going to the club and you're trying to find somebody, then, because I've known in my life I probably had some other young ladies I probably should have stayed with, but I needed to make a change in what I was doing. And I just got tired of every single night trying to remember motherfuckers' names. And I got to get dressed up to go meet this bitch. Fuck that. I got tired. I just ran my course. It just ran its course.
Yeah.
And it takes a while to do that. Like, I would never suggest to anybody, if you're young, to get married, unless you're really, really into that person, to get married at a young age. Because you got a whole life to live. You really, really do. And there's so many different opportunities.
Yeah.
But yeah, I just got tired of it. That's
get
all.
To know yourself first.
I got tired of fucking random bitches and hoping I didn't throw my fucking dick in craps.
And 8 babies later.
So you was going hella raw?
Well, you got 8. You got 12 kids.
Yeah.
Have you ever had an HIV test?
Yes, I have.
Oh.
I don't.
Did you pass?
No, I got it. It's all over this microphone.
Oh, man. Speaking of HIV test.
Thank you for the phone call, baby girl.
I read a hell of an article on Martin Sheen.
Oh, what happened?
Just the whole expose of how, you know, he paid millions of dollars
keep
to keep that whole situation quiet. He was having allegedly having sex with men and women.
Oh, shit.
And this one guy.
Charlie Sheen?
Charlie Sheen. My bad.
You threw the daddy
out. Yeah. I was like,
Martin's the brother.
No,
that's
Martin. No, Martin's the dad.
The daddy. I was like, Martin's.
Oh, not the dad.
He's such a good dad.
Charlie Sheen.
Yeah, the brother didn't use his dad's last name. He kept that.
Estevez.
He kept his mom's maiden name.
No, Charlie Sheen.
Yeah.
And he paid millions of dollars.
You can't get it back.
I think in 2011. It was 2011 when he found out.
Mm. So who is he paying? Like everybody?
All the people that he was having sexual relations with.
Oh, okay.
With.
I'm thinking everybody at the hospital. Look, get that bitch some money too. Motherfucker at the front door. Get him some money.
Nah, the porn stars, mm-hmm. the prostitutes he was paying.
The nigga named Charles.
Anywhere from like $100,000.
Some nigga named Billy. Don't tell.
Just to not say anything?
Not to say anything.
I mean, he admitted it on.
And you think about
and
it.
And then it was when a magazine was going to expose him.
It was Jasper.
Jasper mm-hmm. got paid over $100,000 not to report it. But another blog, but I think National Enquirer or one other online or newspaper was going to report it. But before they could report it, that's when Charlie Sheen went on. That's when the reporter tweeted that he was going to that Charlie Sheen was going to reveal this big secret. Mm. But yeah, Jackie Jasper.
But you figure like this. All the little hookers, they would call like when they rent due. Hey, Charlie, you know what? I'm just going to make this call. How much you need? $20,000. Okay, we'll be there tomorrow. Cool. All right, bye. See you later.
That's probably what they were doing. Having Mm-mm. it, but I don't know how many people actually, if he gave it to anybody.
Yeah, like how many people did he have sex with without disclosing that he
had
that
lot
monkey?
Of people. That was the issue. Yeah. He was going around, this one guy, this reporter who did the story, was saying that that Charlie trusted him with a lot of stuff, and it was times that he would hang out. And people would tell him stuff like him having sex with people without disclosing that he had HIV. So mm-hmm. he was going around with unprotected sex. So he paid the people that he possibly exposed to the virus.
Mm. Before, not to say anything.
Before they even Shit. Knew he had HIV.
And like you said, Jackie, how he exposed it. I remember on his website, he said basically something was coming out in the next week or so. And a big celebrity... And everybody in Hollywood is mad. I mean, is scared. Is going to come out with this big secret. That's how he let it go. He wanted to be the first one to at least sort of say something because mm-hmm. he couldn't really, really say anything. And then we found out. Like I think it was the Today Show. I think broke it. And Matt Lauer, I believe.
I don't think anybody was surprised.
That's my thing. Nobody was surprised.
It was. But I think it was the men, the women, the prostitutes.
But
this,
all those
that.
Drugs, you're gonna end up fucking a goat eventually. He was, he was on so much stuff at one time.
Goat pussy, good.
Right. Sex was just sex at that point. It's like whoever's in the room, come get
rid of
dick.
These flies and these ticks.
That's true.
Yeah, but it was a long article that, and I was like, man, this dude was going around, didn't even catch us. And the reporter that did the story was saying how. He said, you know, because at some point Charlie Sheen was saying he was clean and he wasn't doing any drugs. And so the reporter was like, prove it, you know, come. You
but
know,
didn't
take
he go
a drug
to Mexico
test.
And with the Mexican doctor who used his drug?
Oh, that was this is before that happened. Oh. That he was
right.
trying to say he was clean.
Mm-hmm.
And he had this reporter do a live drug test on the spot.
Mm-hmm.
But they later thinking that he was using some agent in the blood to clean out the to deceive the drug test and all that.
Oh
so,
wow!
Get rid of one of them letters. Get rid of the H or the I.
But you see,
you stupid.
That they're still running his programs on television.
Oh yeah, yep. still getting checked.
Anger
yeah.
management, Didn't. All that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep.
But they're just trying to destroy Bill Cosby, and they haven't even proved anything on him.
That's true.
Wow, that's a nice little comeback there.
That's no, fine. That's real.
No, I like it. I was
like, it's proven that Charlie Sheen has been going around having sex knowing that he's HIV positive. Mm-hmm.
They said, C. Farmer said, Pam, tell Speedy that Estevez is their real name and Sheen is fake.
Yeah, they're Latino.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know,
the
but.
The brother goes by Estevez, one of them.
Yeah, but Charlie wanted to keep his dad's name. And then the younger brother wanted to keep the mom's name. That's all. No, bitch. Who tried to correct me?
No, I don't think they were correcting you. I think they were saying, okay, said, well, Steve Farmer.
Steve Farmer, kill yourself.
Well, yeah, I guess he was the SMH. Yeah, I guess so.
Kill yourself, man. Fuck wrong with you. It's my show. Where he live? I wish one of the Hateful Eight would come here and come be on the show. I'm putting it out there. Please one do. Of you Hateful Uh-oh. Eight, Uh-oh. Get Uh-oh. On the flight, and you're guaranteed to be on the show and come hang out with us and talk all that shit and try to they be funny. And please these do. Are just jokes, and I'm going to slay your ass. Nah, for real. Come on here. Tantizi, come hang out.
Tantizi just said
you and
Terrell.
What's the little boy name?
Tariq.
You and Tariq, come hang out.
Tariq, I'm sorry.
Tariq.
Is it Tariq or Tariq?
I always get it confused.
He's so cute. She showed me pictures of him at the comedy show. I was like, oh my god, I just want
to. Such a sweetie.
Her son.
No, I didn't know what the was.
No, I just wanted to just kiss him. He's so cute.
Aww.
And you want kids? Kinda.
No. No.
How about
Pam,
you?
Pam, would
no.
you ever adopt?
Nope.
You don't want kids at all?
You adopt a dog?
I want a dog.
You want a Pomeranian?
Yeah,
why
good.
Not a little baby?
Because I don't want one. I have my guy kids. I got my little cousins. I'm straight.
Because you're selfish. That's why. Yes. You don't want to share shit.
and then I don't want to get up. I don't want to deal with the shit you're dealing with. I don't want to do that. I'm just good.
Damn, which kids? Is he doing?
Yeah.
Woo.
Nigga. Anyway.
Yeah.
Lots, one.
One, two tops.
And then you're good.
Yeah, straight.
All right. Pete, would you adopt now?
I've thought about it in the past. I can't say that I won't. I don't know.
I could see you with like a little boy or a little girl.
I would rather do programs that mentor young people.
No, I mean, if you had to choose between a boy or a girl, what would you pick?
Probably a boy.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I would want a boy, too.
Really? Mm-hmm. I wonder if I, it doesn't, okay, if
actually,
I had to have
it
one
doesn't
a girl.
Matter.
He'll be a mean little motherfucker.
It wouldn't matter.
My mama said go out. What, little mama? My mama said go out. That ain't even your mama.
That ain't even your mama.
I don't think I would ever adopt, but I would want a boy.
Really?
Because girls are cool except for from like 12 to 16. Then I want to choke the shit out of all of them.
And they want to choke. And because y'all have, I don't know what it is about women and little girls. Because my daughter... Mom loved her. They was buddies till she got in high school. Mm-hmm. She would call me every day.
Oh, shit.
Cheyenne is fucking up. I'm like, oh, shit.
Yeah, see, I can't. I don't know.
Preteen chicks. Because
then you
got
to get a hella early, get them to school, get them
Pam,
on time.
That's part of being a mom.
Oh, good.
You selfish
nigga,
motherfucker.
You should be getting
all
up early
do,
anyway.
All I can do is walk my dog. I'm straight. I'm like, I'm pretty.
Eat shit, you leave it there and go on and out.
Right. Fake like I'm picking it up. But my teeth. Tantizi says coming Monday.
How do you fake like picking it up?
Tantizi, how you coming Monday? Is it a holiday?
She gonna come Monday?
That's what she said. Fuck that, I'm coming.
She not
Monday.
Gonna come. She just talking shit.
Monday, I'm coming. Is what she said.
You talking shit?
Oh, I used to mentor.
Boy, weed is a motherfucker.
I used to mentor teen girls at the Watts Willowbrook Boys and Girls Club.
Did they listen to you?
Mentor. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I had a nice little program going on there. I like working with like teenagers and preteens.
I just
but you don't like working with me. This is that bullshit.
It's almost the same.
Pretty fucking close.
It is almost the same. I just have a higher expectation of you.
Hysterical.
Do you?
Look here, Soul Glow. She looks like an S girl going
waiting,
bad.
You've been waiting.
Yes, I have.
You've been waiting for a long time.
As soon as you
I
say something, almost Jerry Curl ass.
It's fine.
Almost Jerry Curl.
It didn't take on the side. In the front is whipping.
Have you ever had a Jerry Curl like that speedy?
It was never
it
called
take?
A Jerry Curl. It's called a California curl. Is what I had.
Now he difference? Just used that sponge, the little sponge with the holes in it.
And now, had that been around with the Jerry Curl, niggas' curls would have been on head.
Right.
Anyway, I had a California curl.
What's
which
the
was,
difference?
It was.
It was just the.
I don't know. It wasn't expensive.
A Jerry curl was wetter. Right?
Yeah,
is
yeah.
That what it
well,
was?
It really depends on what chemical what you spray.
Yeah, it was the chemical.
I used to use Good
Fred
oil. For those who are not from California, you don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. Or L.A. Good Fred oil was like motor oil for your hair.
Oh my god!
It was really
what?
Like you try to squirt it, it's like it come out straight, and you put that shit in, it will fuck your collars up, your pillowcases, but. Yo, shit is never dry. It was called Good Fred Oil. It was clear.
You still use Murray's, right?
No.
You just bought Murray's the other day.
But it was a different Murray's.
But you bought Murray's, nigga. Murray's Murray's. I just saw you buy Murray's. So tell us.
Now, did
don't.
Ice Cube have a Jerry curl or a
Jerry
California curl?
That was Jerry. Yeah, that was Jerry. Definitely Jerry.
So who had a California curl?
Had a California.
Speedy.
Nigga, nobody cares. Who that we know?
I don't know. I would say Ready for the World.
What did Jamie have? Because his
Jerry curl. Yeah,
his
Jerry.
Because he's from Texas. Was not quite Texas. There.
Yeah, California curl was mostly here in L.A. And it was about $10, $15 cheaper than a Jerry curl. Jerry curl was the top of the line shit.
Yeah. I even had one.
So that was Ready for the World. Who else? Oh, yeah. Ice-T. Eazy-E.
I remember when New York and East Coast used to clown Jerry curls. It was like a trip with the West Coast.
Which was weird because
on the East Coast. They would clown the West Coast about gang banging and Jerry curls, and look, the East Coast is they ended up getting Curtis Blow.
Curtis Blow had the greatest Jerry curl.
Oh, yeah.
The best curl ever would be. Who was that?
That's him.
Oh, wait. Turn it around. I thought that was Eazy-E.
Nigga.
Text me that.
Oh, my God. I thought that was Eazy-E.
Nigga. I thought that was Sky. What is Sky doing in the bushes?
Nigga!
My God,
wait
Ron.
Till we post this picture.
Okay, please text it Ron. To me.
Oh, my God.
You got to
so
send it to
Cali,
us.
That was a Cali curl?
Yeah, that was a curl. Okay, so somebody in the chat room said they had the S curl. Now, what is S-curl the S curl?
S curls came later. Like after Jerry curls.
Yeah, because
after Jerry curls, it was the shag.
Oh, right. My God.
And the best shag ever, two people had the best shag, was Jermaine Jackson.
Hilarious.
And my man from What's Happened.
Dwayne. Yeah.
Dwayne's shit was perfect.
That
like,
was a California like, curl.
No, it wasn't a curl. It was called
was
a shag.
That was
so
a shag.
It was low on the top and it was full in the back.
Oh,
which,
God.
Eventually, they called it a full back. Is what you
it's
asked
like
for,
a black mullet.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, pretty okay. much.
If you had shit was rocking like that, niggas, oh, bitches was losing their mind. They thought you was that dude. Oh, and your boy. O'Brien.
Oh, O'Brien had the best. I think his was California. What you think?
Yeah, it was one of them.
He had the best shag slash.
Yeah, this nigga shit was on fire.
Nigga.
I mean, looking at the album going.
And then it went over his eye a little bit almost.
Oh, my God.
Almost. It was right that there. Was
yeah. I went to the barbershop with that album. I want this. I want that motherfucker. I need to get these bitches.
Yes.
That shit right. But yeah, the S-curl came later when brothers start sweating waves. Because you would get your hair cut short, put the S-curl in it, and then brush it, and you had the waves.
Oh,
if you didn't have that natural hair.
Tontizzi said Troop had California curls.
Troop had California curls.
You're right,
actually right.
I need to pull it up.
Ready for the World. What did they have?
Jerry curls.
Jerry's. Those
they
were Jerry's.
They had Jerry.
Let me see.
It was Jerry'd out.
Yeah, everybody.
And your boy on Soul
world.
Train. What's the dude? He used to have a curl and he used to pop lock.
Oh, the one that's coming on the show. Charles. Charles Washington.
Yeah, he had a Jerry curl.
That's Speedy's favorite Soul
Train. So that's California curl?
Which one?
Speedy, this you have a true. Favorite Soul Train dancer?
Yes.
No, I said I know dude, and I
Charles,
told her.
That's California curl?
Yeah, Troop is a California. Yeah, that, all that's
and
California curl.
Slash
even
shags.
With the curly at the top, and yeah. then they would let the back hang down over your, and it had to hang over your collar.
And be greasy there.
It had to hang over your collar, but that Good Fred oil, woo.
Hilarious.
Anybody from LA, chime in okay. in the chat room if you know what I'm talking about, the Good Fred oil. This is before, what's the brown bottle, which was...
Afro Sheen?
No. I don't know. My mom had a curl, but she used Carefree Curl.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That was the spray.
Now,
yes,
that was
a spray.
Now, see, if they want to go way back, the Kitty Kit.
Oh, that was for perm.
Now,
for kids.
A Kitty Kit I got when I was 12 years old. Did they post a Ron one?
She has even a better one.
Of Ron? No.
Of Ron?
You can't get no better one.
The now one,
no. Ooh, high school picture.
He was cute. He looked like
they
one of the
Ralph
Silvers
Tresvant.
In this picture.
Ralph Tresvant had one. Yeah. It had which one? He didn't say. Just it had
nigga,
it.
Nigga, look at the
that's
stages
Ron?
Of Ron.
Was that on your Facebook?
The black and white one.
Wait a minute. Why are you always looking over your shoulder?
No,
he had different stages though.
You gotta go to Ron's Instagram.
Sky
he followed
is
me
putting
on
up
Instagram.
A picture
uh-huh.
right
this
now.
This nigga got more
DJ
selfies
Ron.
Than I've ever seen.
Now,
in
what was this? Uh-oh. Was this a this was a California curl?
What ages were these?
That's Jerry
curl. What ages were those?
Come see,
yeah, high school. You can tell
us
high school.
Now, was this a California
yeah,
curl
high school.
Or your hair was luxurious?
This nigga, please pull up Instagram.
That was a Jerry curl.
That was a Jerry. Yeah.
This nigga hilarious. Got more boogie
fever.
When you had on that red, you looked just like Eazy-E. A light skin,
I thought
Eazy-E.
That, that's who I thought it was when he showed me the picture.
I thought it was Scott.
You thought it was Scott.
Scott got dimples. Even more. Why is she in the bushes?
Yeah, you had different stages there, though.
What high school, Ron?
I went to Linwood.
Oh,
oh shit.
Okay. Didn't you go there?
Hell no.
You went to where?
Oh, I went to Lenox.
Same thing.
Here. By the Lenox Sheriff Station.
Yeah, Ron.
Soft ass high school. Trust me. Linwood wasn't no joke.
Ron, yeah, you did.
And you was light skinned at Linwood?
If a lot of selfies there.
I mean, you had all the dark skinned honeys was sweating you big time. Hey, Ronnie. Yeah, nigga. Linwood. They talk about yourself.
Talk about you. That's her.
You just don't see Ryan's arm.
No, because he followed me, and I was like, let me check it out and see if I follow back, but I don't have to, nigga. He got 17,000 selfies. It's the same
and she
picture.
She said that he got a flippogram
of selfies. He got a flippogram of selfies.
What's a flippogram?
Where it's a bunch of selfies in a video,
like, yeah, video
with some music to it or something.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
do you
have music to it, though?
Huh? I got to see. You got music?
Yep. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
That's my DJ. Hilarious. Talking about stuff in the third person. That's my DJ. It's me, bitch. Me, bitch.
I bless you.
Ron C.
It's so many.
Follow Ron C. 7 on everything. Ron, DJ Ron C. on 7 on everything.
Or just have him sing you one picture.
And don't forget starting Monday at 10:30 a.m.
Yeah, so you can get your mix
Ron's
on before we go.
Have his own mix.
Yeah, so you can just be and then you could request hit Ron and Ron C7.
Yeah, request your
and
song.
Request what kind of mix you want.
Yeah.
And that way, you know, you can go this
way. See, at least you could request music with Ron with Speedy.
What oh, he would have
you gotta wait for
too.
It to come around.
No, right. Speedy would give you a dirty look, like or Pete, sigh really loud.
Let's just keep it real, Poetess.
What?
We got time. Let's just keep it real. You would be like, so you gonna play that song? I'm like, it's just the song that's on my tablet. I wouldn't like I
but
DJ'd
still,
that song up.
But if you're DJing, you have to be.
No, I'm just playing music.
You have to be aware of.
No, I'm just playing music.
No, you have to be aware of
the
audience.
No, I'm just playing music.
No, well, see, that's what makes a good DJ and a terrible DJ.
So what you trying to say?
That's your
you're terrible.
That's the difference.
She ain't trying to say it.
You're
no,
terrible.
She said
right. When you cater to your demographic and your audience and know what they like and keep
right.
the groove going, that's a good DJ.
Whatever.
Well, we have a call. Caller, what's your name and where you
gotta
calling from?
Gotta be Tom
Deasy. Hey, caller, what's your name and where you calling from? Hey. Caller.
Hello.
Hey.
Did you hang up?
Okay, silence.
We'll
call
back.
To you later.
Silence of the lambs.
Some people get nervous.
It is. 323-293-3375. The question of the day is, tell us about your one night stand that turned into a relationship.
Did you or marry your one
night?
Yeah.
Like that lady call. Yeah.
Do you think you would have married a football player?
Yeah, I would have.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Was your wife a one-night stand at one point?
No.
Mm. I thought I'd ask. It's okay. That's the topic. Don't why you looking at me like that, Speedy?
I know. It's possible.
I was driving here going, what? No, she wasn't. I tried. It's like I didn't try. I always try.
Try what? To make them a one night stand?
Oh, yeah. I do the little.
One take, and done.
Because I go out to a movie, dinner, whatever, and then I take you back to the house. And I'm like, I hit it with, God damn, I'm kind of tired. And if they say, well, you want to come in? You can stay here. Bam! Stick in your mouth.
I can't.
But if they go, oh, okay, well, just
well,
call
I'll
me when you get.
Later.
Yeah, just call when you get
I'll
home.
See you later.
Because I don't never put the Bill Cosby. I ain't going to pressure you. I just, you know, hey, you're going to give it to me. You're going to give it to me because you want to. Mm-mm. Not because I made you do it.
Why do you
or
point
you
at me?
Sorry for
pointing
you.
At the curtain.
Behind her. You point behind her.
She's just in the way.
Okay, the caller call back. Caller, what's your name and where you calling
for
from?
What?
Hey, this is David calling from Kingston, Jamaica.
Hey, David.
Oh, Jamaica.
What team you talk about?
You're in Jamaica right now?
No,
yeah,
2 weeks
Jamaica
from now.
Right now, yeah.
He's paying money for this call. You better shut up. He's calling from Jamaica.
Tell us about your one.
No. I have a phone system, so the call is free.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Tell us about your one night stand that turned into a relationship or a marriage.
Well, I'm not married. I'm single.
Mm-hmm.
But my one night stand, I met this girl in the club. and we kind of got to talking, and she actually gave me a head in the elevator.
Whoa!
And then that kind of turned into a relationship for about 6 months, but she's kind of crazy.
You think? She gave you a head in the elevator.
Right.
Yeah, you know, but as Sweetie says, you know, crazy pussy is the best pussy.
Yes, it is.
It really couldn't last that long, but yeah.
You're Jamaican, so you're crazy as fuck. Crazy begets crazy.
No, like, seriously crazy. I'm not sure if you guys saw that video, but there was a dancehall competition where the girl lights her vagina on fire.
Yeah. Yes, I saw that.
That's an idea how crazy Jamaican girls can be.
Hilarious.
Okay, so let me ask you this. Had she not been crazy, would you have kept a relationship with her?
I think so, but the craziness just got to a point, and then literally like a month after you broke up, I found out she was pregnant. Not me, but another her ex-boyfriend. So she's had the baby and whatever, so we aren't friends anymore, but I'm aware of what she does, and she still kind of is crazy.
I don't think you answered my question.
Let me ask you this, sir.
No, he didn't.
if she wasn't crazy, probably not, because I moved away. I don't know. It probably wouldn't have lasted much longer, because I moved away.
Yeah, crazy pussy.
So it wouldn't have had anything to do with her giving you head in the elevator?
Yes. No, not really. It wouldn't have anything. No.
Really?
Oh, okay.
So why do guys like crazy pussy so much? Crazy girls be winning. Shame. I feel like sometimes
I gotta... All right, to be honest, I think part of it is just the excitement, you know, mm-hmm. the mystery, like how far...
Am I gonna get stabbed or not?
Yeah, if I'm not gonna get stabbed, how far can we go? Because sometimes, really and truly, at the end of the day, if a girl is willing to do things that other girls are willing to do, mm-hmm. sometimes it's just on that reason alone why you kind of pursue this and continue a great relationship. Call. At the end of the day, I think if you are in a situation where... It's predictable and it's always the same kind of thing. You get bored quickly, but sometimes when somebody's crazy, because things are always changing, always moving, it's just on that fact.
Just the adrenaline rush. Basically, you get an adrenaline rush. Okay.
Now, what part of Jamaica are you at right now?
Like, Kingston.
And you listen to the show all the time?
Yeah, I do actually. How I came across the show was you guys interviewed James Rational, and from then I've been listening to the show ever since.
Nice.
Thank you, brother, man.
Cool.
Bug, to
thank
my
you.
Thank you, man.
No problem. Have a good day.
Good day to you, man.
We are national, son.
Find out this nigga here in Chicago. Here in Chicago, and go, goddamn, nigga. They think I'm in Kingston. I'm in Kingston, man.
He's in Jamaica, Queens.
In Jamaican Chicago. Man. You ever fuck in Jamaica?
Yes.
All right, they crazy as cat shit.
Jamaican. Well, he's Jamaican and Puerto Rican.
Whoa. Ooh,
that's very lethal.
It was good times. Good times in New York.
Yeah, my first girlfriend was a Puerto Rican, and so her uncle used to threaten me every time I came by the house.
Really?
Every motherfucking time.
Wow.
With a knife.
But he was 6'4", some change, and at that time I was like 16. Mm-hmm. I was like, please, sir, don't. I was like, anyway, dude. But yeah, he was fucking banana. He used to beat his girlfriend up like every day. In front of the kids, he can get fucked.
Wow.
Yeah.
No, I can't imagine being in a relationship.
I can't either.
But, like, crazy pussy wins, but crazy dick, I ain't with it. Like,
no.
I don't
no,
want
but
no
but y'all will stay with crazy dick for
not.
A minute.
I will
crazy
not.
Dick with fine, maybe. Fine with crazy dick, right. You might take it a little bit longer than you would somebody not as fine.
Just crazy pussy, it just, I don't know what it is.
But I'm not talking about crazy in bed. I'm talking about crazy tick,
no,
tick,
just crazy.
I'm talking about like
no, they're talking about crazy like
about,
that.
Yeah.
But that coochie just happens to be good.
It'd be juicy, wet.
Anyway, it's time for
a break.
Rob. It's time for something.
It's time for Vanessa to go refill her.
Hilarious.
Actually, I'm good right now. I'm good.
You
going
to top it off? All
right. Okay.
Take a quick break. Come right back. DJ Ron, go get him on a Freaky Friday.
Can we do that? Can we? No, it's been a long day. Yeah.
Fuck you back to sleep, girl. I didn't know that's what the song said. I heard the...
I remember when Chris Brown first came out. He was so young, so innocent, so spry.
Now he's fucking you back to sleep.
Right. Carucci. I was like, wow, we just going to throw her name out there.
It is the Roll Out Show. Your boy, Speed Doug.
I was just asking Scott, what is she famous for? Like, is just fucking Chris Brown?
Fucking.
I mean, that's messed up if you're just famous for.
Is she trying to act and host and stuff and got her little stuff in trouble with BET? But yeah, she's trying to do something. At least she's trying to work.
I heard she's really cool as far as like working with her. I know some
really?
People work with her on projects.
We saw her out at All Def Digital about 2 weeks ago.
Uh huh.
Nice girl. I just was like, what else
I played
she
ball
do?
With Chris Brown.
I interviewed Chris.
I played ball.
Okay, who cares? So, I get one of his first interviews. Right, nobody cares. Hey, well, that's when he was a young, you like play ball I said, with sweet boy. Ah, who cares?
Thank you for saying something important, POTUS, because nobody gives a fuck.
He knows me.
I doubt it.
Yeah, bring him on the show. How about that?
Yeah.
Yeah. We'll see how much he knows.
Yeah, thank you, Pam. Right. So every time he says that, Pam,
bring him on the show.
Bring him on the show.
Bring him on the show. Since how well does he?
But he's asked, though. I know that. But what happened when you asked?
Said, who are you again?
It's not who you know. It's who knows you.
Right.
Yeah. Well,
basically, in this business, that's what it is. Mm-hmm. It's like, who
everyone that
you?
Knows me likes me.
Lies.
No, that's not true.
It's your boy Speedy in the building.
Okay.
Hashtag it's false.
Moving on.
To all the ladies out there, it's your boy. Get at me. Mm. If it's your birthday, let me know. I'll give you
a Oh, there is one. And there's one for you, out. Too.
I know. I got to give Sean Ellis a sexy. You get it. Just hang in there, buddy.
That's when you're in the room, clothes off, and she go, I'll be in there in a minute. Well, never mind then, bitch. Yeah.
Wait, well, we have mean to about it. Cue Ron, because you know we got to play some.
Oh, yeah.
Hang in there, saying. Buddy.
You gotta play some nondescript sexy music, or right. it'll violate.
Do y'all like when you walk in the room, a dude got his dick out working it? Y'all cool with that or not?
What you mean working?
If
it?
I like them.
Oh, okay. Sometimes women be like, "What are you doing, bitch? I'm trying to."
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. No, that's yeah.
That's fine with okay. me.
It's cool.
Fine.
Yeah.
You can play with your shit. Who am I to give you permission?
Right.
Who am I to stop you from doing you?
Right.
That was the way you said it. No, go play with your shit.
Go do what you do.
Well, we got some housekeeping.
I'm offering lotion. What you need?
I know.
You want me to help you?
Right. What you need?
Got that coconut oil. Makes your shit glisten. Makes it.
That's what you put on your nice little half shine. A calf yesterday? Oh, sorry. My bad. Anyway, we got some housekeeping
so
to do.
So he uses the same coconut
oil on your dick?
I would hate to touch the bottle. Thanks for telling us. Thanks for letting us know.
You want some coconut oil? No, I'm cool.
I'm good.
Yeah, exactly.
Anyway, I just use baby batter sometimes. Put that on you. Anyway, go ahead. What we got there?
Well, first thing we got going on is a party in Palm Springs.
Party in Palm Springs.
July 21st to the 24th. Comedy show Thursday night. 70s after party. Lip sync battle. Lip got a lot going battle. On. And then we'll be by the pool Saturday. Ron's going to be DJing and stuff like that. So,
And we're going to make Ron dress up like he was in high school with a curl.
Yeah. We're going to have him put that on for the 70s.
Start growing
party.
It out now. Amazing.
Or just bring a wig. We'll take a wig.
Yeah, we'll take the wig.
Right. And then you got what?
Yeah, go to partyinpalmsprings.com for the information. It's sold out.
Yeah, sold out. So
the
you can only buy
package is sold
yeah.
out.
Yeah, you can only buy day passes.
Yeah, so you can sleep in your car and put the band on.
Where are we sleeping?
Oh, we got hotels. We good. Oh. I talked to him. We good.
We got a house.
We good.
Hotels. Not telling with Speedy.
Look, we gonna be in a
cabana. Spin the wheel.
We gonna be in a cabana. So it's
outside
cold out
by
here.
The pool.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna make us some backup arrangements.
Yeah, do that. Wow. Just
you got
in case.
Hookups in
Palm Springs.
I do.
Now the other thing we have going on because we have a lot going on, which is a beautiful thing. We doing a night at the J Spot here in Los Angeles on May the 6th. So we have tickets that we want to sell. They're $10. So what we decided to do, if you're a fan and starting today. P, write it down. Starting today, if you donate from this date on and you live in Los Angeles, you'll get a ticket for free to come to the show.
Is there a
minimum? No, Speedy. That's not what we said. That's not what we said. We're good. $10 donation to either the PayPal or the GoFundMe. And then if you're not in L.A. and you want to, like, donate, we'll give a ticket to somebody you know in L.A. or whatever.
Yeah, to family member,
here,
friend.
And that's on May 6th. So that's what we're saying. So basically, we'll see your name on the PayPal or GoFundMe, and then we'll hit you up and you let us know how you want us to disperse your ticket or if you want the ticket for you.
Yeah, and just let us know that that's what you're doing. I'm donating this for the comedy show on May the 6th at the J Spot. We have the whole night, so we ain't got to worry about
that. Oh, that's good, because that 2 hours wasn't enough.
What's the day?
That's a Saturday.
Okay.
May 6th is a Saturday. And so everybody's going to be doing their thing. Everybody will be there. And again, just stipulate, you know, if you put $20 in, whose name we put the tickets under, they'll be under their name, or they can come pick them
it's
up.
It's a Friday? It's a Friday, not a Saturday. Sorry. Okay.
So, but we have the whole night, so it's kind of cool. It's a beautiful thing.
So you can come later.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then also we have...
on April 29th, the all-white comedy show at the Comedy Union with DJ Ron C. will be there in the building. Wear all your white and for 50 Shades of Funny, yeah?
Yeah.
With Robin.
Do we know who else is going to be on there besides
on that show is Jay Lamont, and Kuba Bites.
Okay.
From New York. And Jay Lamont's from here.
Originally, I love Jay Lamont. He get the party started.
Funny dude. Yeah,
he does.
Yeah,
he gets the party funny. Started.
Yeah, Jay Lamont. He used to be so insecure about whether, you know, people thought he was funny or not, but I used to tell him, dude, just go destroy. Because he kills every time. He one of the there's few comics I'll go, damn, I gotta follow that nigga. He won. Yeah. But I could do it.
For him, like I love him going up last because he does all the music stuff and then once he gets going, people on their feet ready to party. So then you just transition into an after party or something else.
Well, Speedy does that too in his set. You do not the music like thing.
Well, he does. He does. His is a little bit different. But,
oh, okay.
But yeah, very
you're
funny.
You're hosting
dude.
Both, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. So again, as long as, like I said, again, we'll post these things on our page.
Yeah.
We also have something happening on the 23rd, right, Poetess?
Yes, we are. I don't have that information in front of me. But
like, but is that we'll the compunction thing?
Just no.
That's been postponed.
Oh, okay.
FYI, that has been postponed till further notice. But I did just get a text from Rodney Perry. He's on his way.
Good.
So that'll be good. Rodney's great. We're going to start a new segment for the community because we are starting to get a lot of community, PSAs, public service announcements.
And I know what it means.
I didn't know you didn't.
Because you're staring at me like, let me explain to this nigga.
We usually have to.
Right.
Carry on. Anyway, the vision of the studio has always have been to be a voice in the community. So wherever you are, with city, state, wherever you are, if you have something good going on in your community that aims to help others, drop me an email at contact@morrismediastudios.com. We will announce it. And so I don't have that flyer in front of me, but in the next break I will.
Okay, cool. Could you make sure you have it this time?
What?
Yeah. And I didn't get a chance to do my DYK, but I do have DYK.
Fuck my life.
You're
I thought
sleeping.
We were
what
free.
What do you do 48 hours when you're not here? God damn. How long
no,
does
I have it
take
in front
you
of me.
To get a DYK fact?
No, I have them in front of me before the show starts. We just get caught up when we're talking, and then next thing you know, we got to go break.
I think I saw you write it down this break.
No, you were absolutely wrong.
And then freaky tales, right?
I have a DYK for you. Yeah.
Hey, yeah.
This you know the best is. Part of the section.
Here you go. Like, here you go. DYK fact.
That's funny.
That's great.
Now, if you have to pee really bad,
oh Lord,
you can take your mind off of it, or it'll stop that feeling if you think about sex.
Lies.
That's real. You think about sex, it'll stop the.
I've been in the middle of sex and been like, hold on.
Exactly. Yeah, that's a lie, Speedy.
No, please. I'll be back. Give me
no,
a second.
No, it's not.
Wait, what?
Go ahead.
Okay, let me see. Where is hold it? On.
So you've never stopped
which
having
one? This
sex
one or
to go
this
pee?
One?
No, know? No, I'm saying if you have to pee, not during sex.
Can I give you a VYK fact?
A vagina fact?
A vagina fact. If you're having menstrual cramps and you have an orgasm, that will ease the cramps.
It will.
My aunt used to tell me to masturbate before I had my period,
yep.
Like a day or two before, and it would help.
Yeah, but it ain't gonna come out pink.
And during,
ew, no, but this masturbation does
white
help.
In the
but during too, because during it gets all the blood and stuff flowing to get it out, and it'll make your period quicker.
Ron laughed. That's all that matters. Comes out pink.
So that's a VYJ.
Okay, we like that.
Read it again. Read it, Pam.
Okay, when you really need to pee and can't, says Dr. Larry Lipschitz or something like
Lipschitz
that.
Lipschitz was
think
in
about
Chicago.
Sex. Okay, thinking about sex occupies your mind and body and will stop you from feeling the discomfort of having to pee.
Now.
That's because the internet always tells the truth.
Yes, it does.
This is on what site? I can't tell.
Don't worry about it.
So, Wikipedia. So,
it's on the Speedykin site.
Right.
Now, that's just a little DYK. Now, we're back. Live. It is now time for
Freaky Tales.
Hey. We're about to tell you the freaky tales with the freakiest tale in this motherfucker.
Mm. Hilarious.
The Poetess. Give us an all yeah. Hey, what happened to that girl? You used to do that all the time.
Well, I'm doing that for that. I'm going to give Sean Ellis his sexy shout out.
In the words of TDP, I think my
Weenie
can
wiggle.
Wiggle.
Oh, yeah. I should have been a sex phone operator.
You think?
Probably make more money than I am.
It's never too late.
Hey. Poet, is you the shit? They be knowing your name. Anyway, what you got, baby?
This is crazy. These cray, stories cray. Are more freaky in the way that they're like not sexual, but just freaky. Indonesian singer bitten by a cobra on stage, but keeps on singing until she dies.
What? I'm like, oh my God.
Let that song go.
Right.
Karaoke.
Wait, dies?
Well, Indonesian music star Irma Bule was bitten by a cobra in the midst of performance and died roughly 45 minutes later.
Wow.
The snake was part of her act. Oh. But while she was dancing, she stepped on his tail and he immediately...
That freaks me out. I cannot stand.
She known better.
Oh, God.
She stepped on his tail and the cobra struck out and stuck his fangs into her leg. And
who was her security? Nobody saw this happen?
No, somebody tried to come on and give her the anti-venom treatment, but she fanned him off and just kept on singing until she actually started vomiting and passed out on stage.
I love the fabulous. Oh, that's my.
This will be her last show.
Take pictures.
I know the show must go on, bitch, but take a break.
Right.
Get an antidote.
Hey, this shit will save you. Hold on. And I'm telling you.
Oh, really, sweetie?
I'm sleepy.
I will not laugh.
Is that Jesus?
Oh.
I'm in the upper room. Okay, I'll take the medicine now.
Do we have any?
Do we have any
fans in Indonesia?
Oh, right. So wait, she's dead on the stage, right?
Mm-hmm.
And
no.
And the band's still playing. Wake that bitch up.
She started vomiting and passed out, and they took her to the hospital, and she died 45 minutes later.
Yeah, well, it already ran because she's probably jumping around. That shit ran right through your blood system. What did they do to the snake? Snake, like, look, we still doing the show, right?
Find another singer. We can find another singer.
Yeah, bitch stepped on me.
Right.
It was self defense.
I'm a reaction time on my
She did not get the venom treatment.
Immediately. Bitch, you know you got bit.
They had somebody standing by.
But you know. Well,
oh, because they know this might happen. Yeah.
Right. Because it was probably more than one snake. And
I think it was suicide by snakes.
And dude, look, here's the thing. Dude been with her all this time going, I'll be glad when I go on stage. She bit, let's go. Wait, bitch, it's my turn. Bitch, you gonna die. Okay.
It's suicide by snake, like she knew.
She does this in all of her.
No, not no more.
All of her acts.
She don't do this no more. Anyway.
No, she don't. Yeah.
I'll be doing, it's like that Bugs Bunny thing when Donald Duck was trying to do a magic act and all his other shit was failing, but he said, I got one that'll work, but it only worked one time. And he blow himself up.
Oh,
and then the people went crazy. He was like, encore! Like, no, nigga, that's it. See you in heaven.
Wow.
Going to the pearly gates. Well, going downstairs. Oh, shit.
Wow.
Okay. Well, we don't know nobody in Indonesia, so don't trip. Yeah.
Thank you.
That's what they play.
She
could have avoided her own death had she not been...
Took the shot.
She literally took the show must go on.
Way too far.
Yeah.
She did it on purpose. She was done. She was like, I got to perform with these goddamn snakes every day. I'm tired.
How old was she?
It was suicide by snake.
It didn't say how old she was. A man charged for not strapping up his kids with a seatbelt, but instead strapped his cases of beer in.
Well, you gotta have priorities.
That's not like you.
I don't drink beer, except for yesterday, because it was National Beer Day.
It was.
How do you know that?
Internet. Facebook.
That's it.
Alcoholic, no.
Oh, my God.
It was on this my guy, speed.
So anyway, an Australian man was charged with several offenses after police said he used a seatbelt to secure two cases of beer while children in the vehicle were unrestrained.
In the back seat, just romping, drinking
they
beer.
They said they were in a tire well, a foot well. What is
a what?
What?
A foot well? A tire well?
Oh,
something?
Where you put the spare tire?
Oh, shit. Oh,
really?
Yeah. That's not it. Nigga, you hit a bump, it's a wrap.
So they in a pickup truck.
Right.
Or a station wagon.
Yeah.
Because they climb in the back, and that's where you have the... Or a truck.
So
it didn't say.
Let me guess. Florida and white, maybe.
No, that was
Australia.
Australia.
Oh, well, same white. Oh, well. Still white.
Same thing.
How you well, gonna strap they take in their the beer seriously.
They do love yeah. alcohol.
The Aussies love yeah, some beer.
They do. Yeah.
Kangaroo beer is a motherfucker.
And they love Pimm's.
Got a nice little kick to it.
Pimm's. Yeah, they love Pimm's.
Nobody was listening.
Yeah. No, we didn't hear you.
Nice kick.
We have our own conversation over here.
Yeah, we. What you talking about?
Right.
Did he go to jail?
Oh, they said it was Daffy Duck, nigga.
That's what I said. I Donald Duck, Daffy Duck.
They're not the same person.
Yeah, they're
Daffy
two.
Is black. You're very racist.
Oh, yeah.
Donald is white with right. the with the sailor outfit, and don't, Daffy is hey, black.
Hey, again, chat room, don't ever correct me.
correct him all the time.
Let me ride out. All right, what else you got?
There is.
School play goes bad when mm-mm. actors use real blades.
At school?
Oh, shut up.
A school production of a gory play became real life nightmare when two students were slashed with an actual razor mistakenly
shit.
Used during the opening night.
that was the ending night too.
right.
What New Zealand Saint Kindergarten College was in the middle of its second act of Sweeney Todd when two 16-year-old boys had their necks cut on stage.
Ooh, shit. Oh, wow.
Sweeney Todd is real.
What is that?
What is yeah, that? What is that? I've never
okay,
heard
Sweeney Todd is with Johnny Depp and the
it's like a pirate?
The wide-eyed chick. No, it's old times, and it's a serial killer, but he was a barber.
Mm. Okay.
A barber, and he would be.
Are you talking about JD's Revenge?
No.
oh, that would be.
Because JD,
oh
that, he killed everybody with a straight
so he
razor.
He would be lining people up and then.
JD Walker.
And then put them down the thing.
Boss Talker, Baby Slay, Baby Leia.
It was
Pimp
a good movie.
Slayer.
It's he looked like Edward Scissorhands in the movie. But.
Oh, really?
And so they did a play of that, and did they die?
It's about real. A serial killer.
Another dead story.
Why everybody dying?
It's another
today?
Dead story.
It's Freaky Friday.
No,
not
but I do
dead.
This next story.
Mm-hmm.
Man, this reminded me of the Bay Area, but I couldn't be mad at these dudes because they seriously clowned on the streets of LA
oh,
yesterday.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
For those that don't know, Los Angeles is notorious for police chase. Mm-hmm. Every week you're seeing.
Yeah, at least. I'm watching Maury Povich and the shit'll come on.
Yeah, I was mad because I was watching General Hospital. I was like, really?
I mean, have you ever just sat there and watched a police chase?
Well, you do. As soon as they show it, you.
This was the best one ever, though.
Yeah.
Okay, so these guys.
The brothers.
A pair of suspected burglars in L.A.
Allegedly.
Led police on a chase involving a convertible, a TMZ bus, and some donuts and selfies. These dudes.
Convertible Mustang.
I love my
people. The TMZ bus was trying to you know, block them off, but then that one, if that white car hadn't moved, they would have had them, but the white car was like, I'm getting the fuck out of here.
Right.
I love my people.
These like, dudes seriously clown. They did some dumb.
One like a
so
girl. One like a fluffy girl.
Well, we have a little footage of it.
Yes.
Let's
bit.
Go to the footage.
Roll that beautiful bean footage.
Bee footage.
These guys are doing donuts in the middle of the highway during the police chase.
Yeah. We're in the rain.
In the rain.
In the rain.
With the top down.
With the top down.
And somebody, whoever car was like, they fucking my car.
The road's definitely still wet. This Mustang still pushing along out here. That's, look at that. It's going to be Vermont, I believe. Well, the tour bus is actually
trying, I love this part.
He's trying to get out of the way.
The white van, the white truck let him move so he can move.
I would have moved this one. Why did this one stay?
And they're riding out because the top's down.
They chilling.
Look. People in the hood giving them high fives, taking selfies, but they surrendered safely.
Yeah, here's the thing, though. They took selfies till the police came. All right, guys, this is him.
Everybody had their cameras out. I could not believe this shit. I was like, this could go real bad.
L.A. was G for that. Some people thought they were idiots, but I thought
they were idiots, but it was funny as fuck.
Yeah, they were idiots, but...
But here's the problem, though, P. You know if they did it, you know now somebody else is going to try to do the same thing a little bit more bigger,
mm-hmm.
maybe stage it even more where they go all the way to their mama house with selfies.
Yeah.
No? Because that was funny.
Did you guys see the girl run out and she was screaming and then they tried to pull her to the side? There was some girl, like, if you watch the video footage and they were like, bitch, get out of here. And then they pulled her to the side.
I'll say this much. One thing about black folks now, we know when the police come, nigga, hands up, walk backwards to them.
Right.
Nigga, you, I ain't reaching for
they
shit.
They knew exactly.
My nose don't itch. None of that don't reach.
Mm-hmm.
Because you guys, and anybody know
but
in
LA. It took like 10 minutes for the cops to come, too. They sat on that car
well,
for at least 10 minutes.
Because in L.A., they could do a chase,
mm-hmm.
but they can't just willy-nilly all through, especially if it's just something like a burglary.
Right.
So pretty much they could have got away, but the helicopter had them. So there's no reason for the police to endanger other citizens by speeding fast. When the helicopter, once the helicopter gets you, it's a wrap.
Right.
You pretty much, you're done. So that's why they were able to sit there and then the helicopter stayed on them. Be, back in the day, they would, you know, follow them around because it took a while for those helicopters to get there because they only had maybe two helicopters in the city. Now they have like four or five, and then you got all the news people.
The news ones will get you if the police ones
don't.
They
wouldn't
get
you. So they don't have to go through the city. And besides that, they'll get sued. Like if they run into you, you can sue the city.
And then I noticed they tried to strip them a couple of times, but they went right around them strips too, didn't they?
Yeah.
Not one, he rolled over and they still kept going. I'm like, what kind
of shit? No, the tires are messed up though. Hilarious.
But those boys, they were 20 and 19, so they were young guys. They surrendered to deputies as soon as they arrived on the scene.
Mm-hmm. And made it out alive. That's the important part.
Yes, right. Praise God. We're arrested and booked in. They in the county on a $50,000 bail, and one is set at $80,000.
They got a picture of Pam and Alexander on a box of
for
with
the
a curl.
That's funny.
And Pam, you look like you're about 23 and
that's not that long ago.
And he looked like he about 75.
They got that one from the
he looked like Ike Turner.
Yeah. He looks really
we'll
bad.
Post it in a second.
Yeah,
fucking
funny.
Hilarious.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Let's see.
Yeah, that was funny.
I wonder how many people are going to put in on their bail, though.
None of them. And you know the selfie niggas got their pictures posted on their page right now. Getting numbers.
Remember they took the third guy, too, the one that was in the sweats, though, too. I don't know if it was that, because they were telling him to move and he wouldn't move. They were like, okay, you too then. That was like the third
I
guy.
I got one more picture taken. Okay. We got pictures for you.
Were the, those were the sheriffs. That wasn't LAPD. Last story. Japan celebrates their annual Festival of the Steel Phallus.
What is that?
Oh.
You know what a phallus is, Speedy?
Yes, I do.
What?
It's a big ass dick.
Oh, of course he would know that.
How would he?
Hysterical.
Hashtag shots.
The festival allowed
it'd be so easy to get you
crowd goers to celebrate all things that is penis.
Hilarious.
So it's a festival that celebrates penis. The penis lollipops that were for sale. Can we bring that picture up?
I got a few here, y'all want? Yeah. It's just one.
Oh my god.
That was funny. I don't give a fuck what you
the
say.
The penis lollipop.
There you go, Ron. Nigga, you here all week.
Ron, nigga, if you don't take a selfie.
Go ahead, P.
The penis lollipops are on sale for a good cause, though. Raising awareness for
you think?
No pun intended. HIV prevention. People
would you suck
were
one of those?
In the streets.
Pam.
All right.
It's pink.
Hey, it's for
it's
for
a lollipop. It's a lollipop.
Yeah.
Whatever.
But it's
sweets
pink.
Are sweets. It's pink.
What you want to
buy? Yeah, I don't like pink penises.
Did
either.
You bring the picture up?
Mm. Yeah, we saw it.
No, I didn't see it. I missed
little.
It. Oh, I wasn't looking.
Yeah, they had the little pink ones. Though.
Yeah,
I would
it's
like
little
a
and
chocolate
pink.
One.
Yeah.
What flavor is that?
Pepto Bismol.
Oh, yeah, they have those at
like doggy dick.
At wedding, what is those party? Hilarious.
The lipstick. Go ahead, Karen.
Okay.
Yeah, they have those. You can get those anytime.
At Spencer's, too.
They said that
no big deal.
People in the street paraded penis-shaped Shinto shrines called Mikashos.
Very
Mikashos.
Good. Mikashos. Like I said, they walked around with some shit.
Mikashi, right.
Mikashi.
Emphasizing the spiritual roots of the penis. The festival's inspiration reportedly goes way back to the 17th century.
Wow. They've been celebrating penis that long?
Yeah, dick been around for a while.
I mean, you know.
Dick been here for a minute now. Don't sleep on dick. The history of dick is a motherfucker.
I'm sure,
we've
I'm
been
sure you know it, too.
Yeah.
Dick has caused wars.
Yeah.
True that.
No, pussy caused wars.
What was the picture that posted? You either you posted it or commented on it with the pussy cupcakes?
Oh, yeah, the cupcakes. Yeah, I don't know. I got
where can I get those?
I don't know. I just saw it on Facebook, and I was I will not.
And Pam was like, I can't eat those.
No,
I would not.
I wanted to put it on there so bad, I will, but I know motherfuckers be checking my page. Right. So you just eat all her cupcakes. Then not her.
You got to call somebody. You got to be like, Ron C., go on, say I would eat them all.
Right. Ron would get in trouble then. He'd be sleeping.
It's only been a year. He'd be all
right. He'd be sleeping on his turntable.
They got to have some trials and tribulations.
Yeah. They still figuring each other out. They need a good social media scandal.
Need that bull. That's that bullshit. That's why you DJing every night. Fuck out of here. That's it. Why don't you just get a regular job? Oh, you got a DJ? You go to school for that? Because they down.
Can I continue on? Oh, yes, sir. You're just going all left field.
You all right? You all right?
The steel phallus, they have this big giant.
Say it.
Still,
don't call it
black dick. There you like, go. I'm with that. Huge. Mm. So this
Let's
big
talk about it.
Black steel phallus was reportedly erected by a local blacksmith that honored the deities of fertility and childbirth.
Wow.
So basically, prostitutes were believed to have prayed there for protection from sexual diseases.
They prayed to the dick, to
all the
big black dick.
The dick like,
please don't give me BD.
What?
So, it's closed. What time did they go? You get these prayers in. Is it 6 o'clock? Cool, I'll be back at 6.
Do you have a picture?
Doors open.
I cannot.
I'm just pray by these balls.
Be on the desk.
Ooh, it's wet in here.
What?
Is it raining?
Why is it so sticky?
She's about to bring up the gigantic.
Oh my
no,
God.
Yeah.
It's
huge.
Do.
It's like on
I would
a
love
shrine
to see
and they parade it down the street in a big, almost Pope Mobile, wooden Pope Mobile.
I'm with it.
A big old dick coming
a
down the street.
A big old black dick
on top of it.
Do you know how scary the black penis is to people around the world?
People are so fascinated.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, it's got penis. Like,
it looks like
is
a
it circumcised?
It looks like a microphone.
Pam. Like they left the skin on it.
It looked like it left the skin.
But it got a condom on it. What is that?
It's a beanie. It's called a beanie.
No, I'm talking about the plastic underneath the head.
Hysterical. And they have it in a
shrine.
And they're trying.
They are protecting it from the elements.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, water will shrink it.
Don't let it get cold.
Get cold, motherfucker.
It's over.
Oh, my God.
They say people come from all over the world.
No pun intended.
To pray for good fortune and to ask the gods to protect them.
Okay, ladies. Let's say the prayers work.
Uh-huh.
Would y'all go pray
to the penis?
Pray to the penis?
Yeah, would y'all be?
Would you worship the dick?
Would you?
Nigga, no.
Would you get on your knees?
No, I couldn't do it.
I can only worship dick that I've had inside of me.
Right. And it's good.
Yeah.
It's got balls at the bottom, too.
You think it's a dick? What the fuck is you talking about? If you go pray to the real dick, it need balls.
But are they like sitting on the balls? Like, oh.
Yeah, like.
Like, I don't understand.
I wonder if they got hair coming out. Oh, got hair.
There was no hair. It was smooth.
Yeah, it was smooth, definitely.
It was smooth.
You like it smooth, hairless? You?
I would prefer, like, keep it up.
Yeah,
a little manscaping, because nigga, ain't nobody trying to cut up your face and rug burns and shit.
Especially, I just peel it back to the.
Peel it back.
Peel it.
Take the hair
you got
back.
A turtleneck?
No, I ain't got no turtleneck.
Don't lie.
Don't
you
have
said peel back. Nobody peels back hair.
Anyway, roll it back where you look like a lion.
Rolling it back implies turtleneck
like
again.
Yeah, the lion had the little
mane.
Yeah, so I pull it back.
You're not circumcised?
Yes, I am.
You done rolled it back, pulled it back.
I am very circumcised. All my kids are. I ain't want them.
Nobody.
Because women would always tell about other dudes, his shit was nasty and shit coming out.
Yeah, because I'm sorry, that's not sexy.
Which is really weird that it could be a DYK.
Jesus.
Back in the day when my sons were younger, they would circumcise them right then.
Yeah, at the hospital.
Now they don't.
They did because
they charge,
godson,
but they charge you. They charge you because they say that you want it done, but you have to pay for it right then.
Wow. Well, I'm sure
you need it immediately.
Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. Why wait? What are you waiting on?
When they won't remember, because do that shit when they 16. They mad. They are hateful.
Ooh, you're gonna get it all in. You just get little snippets.
Mm. You gotta do it.
Got the halfway turtleneck.
But if you do it right then, I know you have to pay extra, but isn't it, since you're already in the hospital, isn't it all under insurance?
It used to be. Not anymore. Not as
so
not
how
anymore.
Much how much does it
it's
cost
like two,
to get rid of the
280 or what? It's like 280. So like Brooklyn, when Brooklyn was born, I had to pay out of my pocket at the hospital. I was like, no, cut the beanie out.
Sky says that nowadays they don't do it in the hospital, and the insurance companies won't pay for them. You have to go to a clinic to get it done.
I think it depends on your insurance, because I was with my godson when he got his done, so we rolled him down.
They're saying
she was at Cedar.
Considered cosmetic.
Yeah.
But is it cosmetic? Isn't it health reasons? Because you can get bacteria.
Or religious. Don't people do it?
Yeah. Just call a rabbi. They'll do it for you.
Right. Exactly. That's what I would do.
But they use a real pair of
scissors. But you're not Jewish.
Look,
they
use a real pair of scissors, though.
Well. He ain't going to remember. He will not remember. Wow. Like, it's 20 minutes old.
Right.
Yeah, but back when my sons were little, they did it at the hospital right when, because they would ask you, do you want, I was like, cut all that shit off. You don't need all that.
I hate
as I was
so
shaping
much.
His little head, because he had a little dip in his head. Let me get this.
Must be talking about Donald.
Right.
Yeah, Donald looked like Baby Huey when he was born.
Really?
Yeah, straight. And then
he still ain't grown into his head.
Hysterical.
He's like Baby Huey. And Nick looked like Tweety Bird.
That's the fine one. Yeah, right there.
Nick? Mm-hmm, I cute. Think, what's his name? What's the
you
one
guys do know I'm here.
Who's the one that works for Jamie?
That's Justin.
Justin is the one. That's
okay, we have a call. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Hey, this is
Tantizi.
Oh,
hey,
shit, Tantizi. I thought we'd go a whole show without
me. Shut up.
You've been asking me to call.
No,
yeah, you did. I had my son 2 years ago, and all of that was covered under the insurance.
Right.
You had really good insurance, though.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I guess that was.
Yeah.
You wasn't on Medi-Cal.
You wasn't on Medi-Cal. If you're on Medi-Cal, they're not paying for it.
Oh, yeah, because that was all covered. They asked me if I wanted to have it done. I said yes, and they did it. And
like a couple of days later, right, Tantizi?
No, they do it then.
Same day.
You said you felt bad, Tantizi?
Yeah, that stuff looked like it was pain.
Yeah, it looked.
Yeah, he was crying.
And the baby be crying, but they figure you cry when you came out, keep crying. Right.
You're not going to remember, but you're going to be happy later.
Right.
Yeah, that is true.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and the chat room had a question for Vanessa. They wanted to know, how was your experience at George Lopez's house?
Oh, that was amazing.
You niggas are the worst.
No, I thought they were going to ask something crazy. I had a great time.
Fucking worst. Tantizi, I hate
messy,
you.
You messy.
I hate you.
Union rep. She's just doing her job.
You get your ass down here Monday so we can.
I won't be here. I just said I had a great time. That's it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye. But if you can come Monday.
Uh-oh. I can't come Monday.
Yeah, she.
You can go Wednesday.
She got to get circumcised.
You can come Wednesday.
So you can hang out with Precious.
Yeah, just come hang out, though.
Yeah, I'll hang out with my girl.
Okay.
All right, guys.
You so messy. Bye.
Nobody knows you. Tantizi. What's her real name? Tanya?
Tanya. Duh.
I thought it was Teezy. I thought it was Teezy.
Good one, Steve.
I'm funny when I need to be, baby.
Allegedly.
Is that right? You got a word of the day since Kente ain't here?
No. Yeah, nigga, that's not my
got
shit.
Another DYK.
Yes,
for
I
us?
Do.
Oh, no. Let's get some music.
Well, this one everybody knows.
I want the music.
If your throat okay.
Can we get the music? Yeah.
Do it again, Potus.
Do it again, Potus.
Another DYK fact with Speedy.
Yeah.
But everyone knows this one. When your throat tickles to scratch your ear.
Oh, you said that one.
You said
right.
That. You did that.
Yeah, but I'm just saying everybody knows that.
Do you have Alzheimer's?
He wasn't prepared.
I'm like, yo.
I mean, did you get it once, Sky?
You did it all.
Oh, you know, Sky had a joke.
The internet is a place where you can find millions
of dick facts.
Thank you.
Yeah, you know.
First of
stop
all.
Stop being lazy.
I know everybody knows this. Why are you going to give it to us then?
Well, I'll just double check.
It's supposed to be stuff we don't know.
We know it now because you already told us.
Right. We want to do another one now, Speedy. Fuck it. You know.
Yeah, we do.
But we do have a new segment. She doesn't have music yet.
She's not ready. She's not ready. Today.
What mean, in can, the fuck?
What kind of stuff am I working with?
How the fuck you not ready?
Okay, hey, first of all, I can do something.
Can you
but
put on some sugar-free if you stay ready? You ain't got to get ready. God.
No, there's something we can do. But
no.
We talked about this before the show started, and they said, do you want to do it today? I was like, I didn't bring the stuff. It's whatever.
How you know bring it? You asked yesterday, hey, I got an idea.
I said an idea.
You informed us. Where's Tom Teasy when
we just talked about this? We can't put on black, like.
But we just talked. We talked about it before we went on air because this nigga ain't get his dick facts together.
Whoa. Mm.
Ooh, it done got ugly.
You got that song ready, dog? Play that shit. Get ready to be ready.
Oh, I got some hacks.
Then come on.
Come on with it. Just give us a couple hacks.
Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Give us an introduction to what to look for for next week or whatever.
So hateful.
What's the segment?
It's life hacks, ways to accomplish things without spending so much money or taking a whole lot of time to do them.
Okay.
With
so
Vanessa.
We'll hear what that on Wednesday. Right?
With VG. I would say it like
VG,
that.
Yeah.
With VG.
Yeah.
Hmm. Yeah. I'm one for me, nigga. What?
Our VYG fact.
Yeah.
VYG.
Yep.
VYG.
Again, right, Sky. What is it?
No, VYK.
Yeah,
Vanessa.
VGK.
Don't try to figure it out Vanessa, after you already
know.
Killed it.
Vanessa, you know?
Vanessa, you know? No, Vanessa, you know. All right, so again, it's called?
We don't know yet.
Well, I mean, what is it you're going to do?
It's life hacks.
Shit.
Sugar free.
We gotta get Sugar Free on the show.
I love him.
He performed last year.
Everybody.
I want Quick
at the Palm Springs.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. And oh, he gave. Did he bring you on stage?
He just was giving me shout outs all night.
Here's the thing: we're in the lobby and they're waiting on him to come. He finally walked in and P said, "I'm out. I'm going to go see him.
I'm going backstage."
Really? What the fuck?
One thing I do hope. With Palm Springs this year, is that they have a better sound system. They just have
it's a different venue, so possibly.
Yeah.
You know.
But I think they bring their own sound system, if I'm not mistaken.
It seems
I think
like
that's generally.
Hotels, it just seems like hotels
ballrooms.
In general don't have good sound systems.
Well, going through this bullshit up here.
What?
It's going through this bullshit.
Oh, did you burp?
Nope.
Oh, yeah,
you burped.
Did it come out on the camera? I mean, on the microphone screen?
This stupid motherfucker. All right, here we go. So this is a little bit of what you might be doing. Okay, go.
She just explained it.
I just said what it is.
All right, let's go.
No, next week. She's not ready.
Oh, I thought you said you had a couple.
No, I do.
Okay, then do those.
Go ahead. Oh, it's fine.
We just got to get you some intro music.
Yeah. Right. Like that's.
I told her she's got to prepare.
The whole situation.
But just give us one.
Okay, so one for ladies, if you're ever going out from daytime to nighttime and you're not prepared.
Like don't... now?
You're wrong, sweetie. Go ahead.
I'm the greatest.
You done? This is what we doing? This is what we doing?
No, go ahead. I'm sorry. Ladies, you're going out. You're not
you're
prepared.
Going out. You don't have like your makeup kit and everything together, but you want to switch from a daytime to a nighttime look. All you need is whatever lip gloss or lipstick you have. And then you can dab it on your cheeks, rub it in for blush, put it on your lips and a little bit right under your right on your eyelid, and then you have a nighttime look from the daytime.
That makes sense.
It changes
your
look.
You have a scarecrow look.
No, you do not. That's if it's black. How much? What color? Look.
No, you're right.
So you're saying this one right here.
Yes.
That's too light, though.
That's too light. Mm-hmm. But like, if you have a different color lip gloss or lipstick, it'll
most people care. Most
like this
women
right
carry
here,
red,
right? This will change your life.
Okay, let's go. Give a demonstration. Is that me?
Yeah, that's you.
Do a demonstration.
Yeah.
Really, really?
Nigga,
need to turn off
they're
your
not
phone?
Gonna be able to
let have one of us done that.
Go ahead.
Just got his phone out the fucking car.
Somebody at the gate?
Yeah, somebody at the gate.
Oh.
Rodney Perry?
No. Go ahead.
Are you excited to meet Rodney?
She loves him.
That's
what she
my friend.
Saying.
I love him to death.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, so demonstration.
So regular.
Mm-hmm.
Little gloss. I had to change this to the mirror.
We're coming, motherfucker. Wait.
Yeah, please speedy, put on silent.
All right.
Little dabble.
Oh, that looks great.
Yeah. Now I have on blush.
Lipstick. It actually looks great. And that's a really good idea. Actually, I never really thought about that.
And then you can.
No, Pam, as much makeup as you have.
Oh, shit.
I do. I have a.
Are
a
you
troll.
Calling her Bozo?
Really?
Are you calling Pamela?
I did not say that, Speedy.
I don't have a lot.
Are you calling her the Hamburglar?
I think hilarious. Pam wears her makeup very well. She looks.
Are you
natural.
Calling her Ronald McDonald?
And plus, she has nice skin. She doesn't even need to wear a lot of makeup.
She does.
I don't know why
eyes.
She wears makeup.
It's my eyes. I have dark circles.
And that's
like, it's because I don't sleep.
So lipstick, ladies, if you trying to. This okay. Okay, so that's good. Okay.
Looks great.
Yeah. I don't know about great, but.
Stop speaking.
Tell you, hey, his lipstick, now, his lip is going to her face.
Are these hacks just for women? Or
no, there are other ones.
You have another one?
I do.
Give it to me.
The best thing you can do while people are spending all their money on like Beats pills or just trying to get speakers, spending all those money.
Speakers. That those would be kind of speakers, pills. Not those kind of pills. I don't, actually, mine are free.
What you can do is take an old, that's why I said I didn't have it with me, but you can take a toilet paper.
Oh, yeah, I see
the thing
that.
In the middle.
Or a cup.
Cut a hole in the bottom. I mean, cut a hole in it, put your phone through it, and it's instant amplification.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Yeah, I've seen that.
Like, I've never seen that. Okay,
or you can put it in a cup.
I don't get it. Wait, wait, wait. Okay. In the toilet paper thing?
Yeah.
The toilet paper roll. So if you take a toilet paper roll, you cut a hole out in it so that it can fit your phone.
It is a hole.
Because, no.
Where the speaker part is.
Oh, okay.
Boy,
the top. And you put it inside like this. It will amplify outside.
There is a hole.
It'll amplify out of the hole you speak of.
Interesting. Okay.
Nigga.
When we go to break, I'll
Did you say there is a hole already? But my phone don't fit. It's round. How you get it in there?
I'll do it when we go to break.
I just see her at home going, this shit.
Wait, it worked for a pipe, but I don't know.
Oh, damn.
I can do it a pipe out of it, but I don't know how to do it.
Damn.
Oh, shit. She got, I ain't no fuck up this pipe to put no speakers on it.
Right. Pipe potential.
That's why she was really fucked up with
let's
it.
Let's take a quick
break. Yeah, let's take a
what?
Quick
why are we taking motherfucking breaks? DJ, ladies in the building. Hey, ladies, how y'all doing?
Friends of mine. Oh, they're your friends?
From Chicago.
Okay.
They're all the way out here
they
visiting.
They're cute. Real cute.
Why are you surprised?
Because they're your friends?
Yeah.
And they're about 100 pounds lighter than
what we normally see.
But I think it's first time I met her, the other young lady. What's her name?
Precious.
You think? That's a black name right there. Precious is my name.
Yeah, I don't think they're I've ever cute. Met a white person named Precious.
No.
No.
No. They're a black dad. No. Thank you, Sky. Hey, Sky. You know you and Ron C got the same pictures?
With the red shirt and everything.
Really? Really? Hilarious.
Just in some bushes. That's all it
you're
is.
You're wrong for that.
It is the all-new Rollout Show. It is Freaky Friday. Ron C, what you got for these big old freaks out here? Play something for them. We'll be right back. Don't move. We got a whole lot of the shit. Turn the shit on.
Problem got my whole.
Yeah, that shit was bad.
Pandora.
Yeah, Problem got Beats.
Oh, that was Problem?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't hear what he said.
Isn't that Sky's favorite artist?
One of them.
One of
them. And my new favorite artist.
I like
as
him
well.
Too. I like the new West Coast that's out right now.
Your speakers, your mic sounds far away.
Can you hear me now?
There
yeah.
You go.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I like
Pandora,
YG. I
truth.
Like Problem.
Mm-hmm.
Glasses Malone.
RJ. Okay, cool. It is the all-new Rollout.
We're like, who? No.
It is the all-new Rollout Show right here at Morris Media Live. It's your boy Speed Doggy Dog in the building. What's that? Mm. Anybody celebrating birthday, just let me know.
I'm the poetess.
Yes, you are.
Nikki Pam.
Vanessa Graddick.
Why?
Why? Because her mama named her that.
So you're on the fence about the George Lopez shit?
No. That's not what I'm on the fence about.
What are you on the fence about?
She said, okay, I whispered something to her, and then she said, well, I'm on the fence if I'm going to tell it.
No, she told me something that as a friend, BFF,
right.
I would not say to the world. Mm-hmm. And then you said, you ain't going to tell me. And she said, I would never tell you. And then I said, well, I'm on the fence because I don't know what you said about George Lopez's house. So I may have to tell. But until I listen to the archives from last
Speedy
Monday, said I'm
that
be
he
quiet.
Said you ain't going to make it.
He did not.
I'll just play it.
And I never said that. All I said was you had a spiritual experience there. And you
they said you were in tears.
Up,
you were like
tearing up a little bit. Remember you said to me, I think I'm going to cry.
Because he talked
you
to
you.
No, not because he talked to me. It wasn't,
words.
And it wasn't just him. It was a conversation with him, DL, Arsenio, just talking about because
comedy.
As being a comedian, you know, you have your ups, your downs, and I've been down. Like I've lost everything, and so talking to them and them saying, you know, well, what you got to get back out there, you have to do whatever. Because I know I'm in my own way. So it was a.
And then he told George told her a story about him being in
him
you know,
coming up and
all the stuff he's been through. And stuff, so.
When he
and
went,
you cried.
I did not cry.
She almost.
Well, the word we got with you cry.
Yeah, well, I said almost. You know Nick Cam. Yeah, they
said you,
extra.
You said you was tearing
I
up.
I was okay. like, I said I almost so teared now, up what a little you bit do? And I had a lot okay. of tequila.
Whether you cried or not, that could have been an emotional experience for you. But what are you going to do as a result of that? What will you do different now that you've had that experience?
No, it's just going, being, again, getting out of my own way. So yeah, when I get off work, I go home and chill. But this week I've gotten on stage twice. I went out to Flappers yesterday. I had the show at the Comedy Union, and I'm getting back active like I was when I first started.
Yeah, you just got to get out there. Yeah, just do your stand-up.
So anyway, that was inspirational to you.
You cried.
Right?
Let's move on. Anyway, you cried. It's Freaky Friday. Mm-hmm. Question. We do have some young ladies here. We should ask them our house question. So come on, have a seat, baby. Come on, one at a time.
One.
Come on, one. Oh, Precious? No, just one. We do one. And have a seat. Precious, right?
Yeah.
All right, Precious. From Chicago. Anybody from Chicago out there?
Midwest.
Hold on, these ain't even plugged in, baby girl.
Oh, Lord.
Just take a hot second to do this. Now, you got your thighs all out? Okay, shit. Ron showed it to me, otherwise I wouldn't know. Because Ron was staring. All right, so our question of the day is, have you had a one-night stand that turned into a relationship?
That's a good question.
Get really close on that mic.
I have not.
Your mic's not on. Her mic's not on, Sky. Yeah, she's got to turn the knob or some shit.
Okay, try it again.
Go ahead. Give it a shot.
I have not had a one-night stand.
Like
really?
Never?
Ever?
Never.
Oh, you like 20-something.
No, I'm not.
How old are you?
31.
Oh.
Wow.
It's, we're like, whoa.
It's on my bucket list.
It's like
list.
A unicorn and shit.
It's on your bucket list.
Oh, to have one?
Don't say that on this show.
Yeah, this is going to happen for you. Trust me.
I'm taking it back.
Hey, bitch, you said you wanted a bucket list. Take this dick in the bucket. like you've been all like, dude, like y'all want to come through. You're like, no.
People are creepy.
That's true.
They're creepy.
Speedy. Oh, sorry. Fuck, I forgot my mic was on.
The fuck? So that's why you haven't had a one-night stand. But you want to.
I think
stay close on that.
I think every person should have one.
Mm-hmm.
But I have not had.
What you waiting for?
The moment present itself. I haven't had anyone that I was like, yeah, I'm having a one-night stand tonight.
You're just being responsible.
Right.
Maybe that's what it is.
That's a good thing to be.
No, no. Need you be a little bit more loose.
Really?
Go on and get the dick. Just hey, nigga, what your dick do?
God, sweetie.
In the words of the other precious.
Other precious.
Oh, Lord.
There's another precious.
But you said we can't say that. You're not supposed to say that.
No, I said if you ever want to really scare a dude off, that's like starting, like, come on, nigga, show me your dick. And every dude would be like, oh, you stupid. Maybe one dude might pull his shit out. Uh-huh. This is Jamaican, nigga. He show your DB pull.
Right.
But the average dude be like, oh, bitch, you tripping. No, I'm going to come back here and fuck you. Come on back here, I'll fuck you. Nah, I'm cool. I'm just going here and dance.
Because you want to be the aggressor. Because
guys want to be the ones that think they turned you around. Even though, like she said, in her mind, okay, I'm going to fuck him. But we don't know that. We thinking we opened the door or I said something charming and that flipped the strip and you was like, oh, shit, this nigga.
Yeah, I don't know what word he was trying to say right there.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, I'm a little confused.
Don't worry about it.
Shout out to public school.
So do you have a man at home back in Chicago?
I'm dating.
Mm-hmm. You don't listen to the show? Don't worry about it.
No, I just got out of a long 7-year relationship. So now I'm like,
ready for that one night stand.
Yeah, there we go.
Trying to see that one night dick. Cool.
How long are you in L.A.?
They're here to Sunday.
Till Sunday.
Okay, so you got till Sunday to get see what that dick do.
Don't see what that dick do.
No, don't do that. Don't.
But then she go back and never have to see him again.
Because I'm young. I'm the youngest person in here.
Nobody cares about you.
But I'm telling you.
Listen to her.
I'm telling you, do not get a one night stand in L.A. You know Vanessa.
Right.
You know better. Don't set her up for failure.
You're throwing her under
but
the bus. But
it's not throwing her under the
bus. Hey. I have to speak for all the brothers out there listening to the show. Don't listen to her.
But here's the thing.
Get your dick.
If her bucket list.
That's her bucket list.
Her
now.
Bucket
can't
list
sleep
is
on
a one night stand. Why not have a one night stand where you never have to go back? She don't have to see
I'm coming
this nigga.
Back, though.
Listen.
And I usually have stalkers, so I wouldn't want him to, you
so
know.
So go to Utah and do a one-night
stand. Maybe over
there. Nigga, did you say Utah?
Utah. If you go there for that one-night stand.
Hilarious.
She said go to
Utah.
And you never come back.
Funny as fuck.
Let's bring
thank you, baby girl,
thank
for
you so much.
Hanging out with us, Precious. So, do you want to give your information? Just no, I'm playing. Blow your shit up.
Hey, bitch, I'm in town. What do you want to fuck me or what?
Precious,
in
good luck,
the building.
Baby. Good luck.
He from Chicago, too.
A one night stand to happen.
He originally from Chicago. My fellow Virgo in the building.
Hey, Nick.
Rodney, motherfucking Perry.
I'm excited.
Oh, you went with the great, too? I went with the great. I said, fuck it.
You went all the way with the great.
Well, I didn't want to.
I got a little, you know.
Soul patch.
Brown patch.
Hilarious. Rodney Perry is
What's
in
up,
the
man?
Building, nigga.
Speeder.
Don't book
What's
me.
What's up, baby?
Don't book me. It's okay, Rodney.
Oh, here we go.
You're talented.
Hilarious.
But is he not talented enough to book?
Can you turn his mic up?
No, this is the deal with Speedy.
Uh-oh.
And I've explained this to him before. Let's start right here. First of all, Speedy has successfully booked me maybe once.
No, Rodney. Several times.
Successfully, though.
Successfully. That's the key word. Thank you.
No, but that wasn't my fault. That nigga didn't have the money.
Let me explain.
And Rodney said, Rodney
Let me
like,
explain. Let me explain, Speedy. So, Speedy hit me up. Rod, got a gig. Da 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 da. And it happened the first time.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is. It was beautiful, wasn't it?
It was beautiful.
Okay.
The difference between that gig and every other gig is at some point in the process, Speedy go, Rod, you know, you owe me one now. And I said, Speedy, don't say that. You're going to jinx it.
Right.
And without fail, they all fall through.
Because they call your people, and they go, and the dude call me back, hey, man, this nigga need 6 first-class tickets. I said, who? Rodney Perry. I was like, oh, shit. And he want...
sausages.
He want talcum powder in his room.
Talcum powder.
He want a portrait of Jesus, the black one. I can't even find the black one.
Know what a black one is.
Nigga,
hello.
That's just...
Black
that shit's still on a good time set. Rodney Perry from Chicago. The young ladies are from Chicago.
Yeah, she's quite lovely. Hey, ladies, Chi-Town, South Side, what's up?
You ain't going to introduce yourself.
I'm Rodney. Rodney Perry. Hi.
They know that.
Speedy.
They know him.
I'm something like
that. And here's the weird shit, because we both Virgo, so we always think a lot about certain shit. So last show we did was in Oakland.
Oakland?
For the football player's dad.
Yes.
Me, you, Guy,
we didn't get paid
Joe,
that
Joe,
night.
Tory. Yeah, Joe got paid because Joe threatened to shoot
Joe
the nigga.
Joe tried to kill the guy.
Are you serious?
So man, and so he come down the hallway, which ain't never really good when they come in the hallway before the show. We look outside,
man,
it was this many people, and the place held about 3,000. It was this many people.
Really?
So my man said, hey, man, so, and Rodney said, I don't even want to talk right now. Don't even want to talk
you
to
you
right
it,
now.
You ain't got it, bro. He had the posture of, I don't have it.
Yeah.
Right.
And man, so, you know what? My son, man, he said he was gone.
He played Sunday.
Yeah,
the show was Saturday.
Man, he played Sunday. Oh, just put something in my account, man. It just ain't in.
If y'all can wait till Tuesday. And Rodney said, nigga, we are leaving in the morning.
I got that video still.
And
we always making videos. That
really?
That was when viral stuff was starting to happen. Uh-huh. So I just started recording.
Funny. And I said, man, because I was going to stay in Oakland. So I said, I'll stay. And he paid me.
Did he?
Yeah, because his son had the game Sunday. His son at the time was playing for the Rams.
I don't know if I ever got paid for that.
No, I got paid. I stayed.
So you and Joe got paid?
Joe got paid that night.
Oh,
Joe hit him with that Tory logic.
Yeah.
Either you pay me or you die. Or I murder somebody. However you want to do it, I'm going on stage. First of kin, second of kin, who you want?
Yeah.
Wow.
And the nigga went, he found that money.
You look so beautiful.
What are you talking about? Well, you was glaring this way, nigga. I was like,
I'm
sorry, you were gazing.
I never gazed.
You gazed.
I never gazed.
You gazed.
He didn't gaze.
I don't gaze.
You gazed.
He didn't gaze. We haven't seen each other in quite some time.
I don't gaze.
You gazed.
Rodney Perry.
Speedy is hateful.
This is my name.
I love Speedy.
When I tell you,
even though most people don't like Speedy, I
had a bitch.
Because he owe everybody money.
Thank you.
Successful shows.
That's not true.
I just told Speedy there are people that, you know, love you less or like you less than we do.
Ah.
And you're gazing again.
I'm looking at your hair and I don't like it. I don't like it one bit. I don't like the fact that you have twists like you're young. What the hell? What the hell are you doing, Speedy?
I hate you. Fucking
what are you doing?
Cause my hair's growing. I'm supposed to cut it because it's growing?
Do you have a sponge? Do you sponge?
Yes, we were just talking about that. He has a sponge.
You sponging, dude?
Yes, he is. Is that
sponge?
You know,
and
you know
oil.
First of all, I've sponged before. let's
but
go
you were younger.
How no, old were
not,
you?
Last year. I was in the sponge class.
Okay.
Year. Yeah, I was way ahead of the sponge curve. But anyway, but Speedy, you predate me at least a decade.
Oh damn.
And you're guest that. Of who again?
I'm going to be quiet.
You're guest of who, Rodney?
The poetess.
That's
yeah.
right.
The poetess. I love the show. I watched the show.
She oh, wow. hit me like I didn't know Rodney Perry will be there tomorrow. I was like, and?
So? Man, we go back, man.
We go back, man. When it wasn't cool. And then it became
Speedy,
cool.
IZ, funny.
Wait. It wasn't cool.
Just the comedy game.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I thought you met him with each other. Okay.
And then Rod, you know, he's a successful comedian. He's out there doing it.
Yeah, he's very successful.
In some circles.
Living in ATL.
He's extremely successful.
Less successful than others.
You know, Fox is down there.
Fox is down?
In Atlanta.
Oh, shooting a movie.
Yeah, shooting a movie.
Yeah, I heard about that. Yeah. I heard about that, yeah.
So you're here for, you're out in L.A.?
I'm shooting a couple of episodes of a show on Bounce TV called Family Time with Omar Gooden, Angel Conwell.
Yeah. We had Omar on the show.
Yeah, Omar's a dope dude. We play dominoes. Oh.
Yeah. No, I play with them. You, man.
Oh, really?
It's not hard.
You've never
to fix. It's
never.
Not hard to fix that.
Well, I mean, hey, what you doing?
I'm on the show right now. Okay. After I finish,
excuse me. Right. We got some dominoes here. We'll break them out. We'll
but it is Freaky Friday, and we were talking.
What
I
does
know,
that mean?
You know, you're happily married, and
I am.
We'll get
am.
Past that. the question of the day
I've known
was,
all your
kids,
exploits, or children,
the kids.
Yeah, look at your phone.
I would never
before you got married.
Let me record you live while you say it.
Before you got married. Now the question is, have you ever had a one night stand turn into a relationship?
I'm my wife.
Wow.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, this is the thing. Like, I've never been the guy that thinks a one night stand is because the girl is a whore.
Yeah, me either.
You know,
either.
To me, it's I something I said or did that made that happen.
What I just say.
That's, yeah.
But that's Virgo. That's like
that's how we feel.
That's arrogance of who we are.
Yeah.
Ooh. That's the. That, it's probably now. She probably was a raging whore, actually. But in my mind,
it was something,
it was
something
I said that made her go.
One joke. She
her.
Said,
"You know what?
I'm a fucking.
I normally don't.
Mm-hmm.
But
you are Speedy."
You are Rodney.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you gazing at me? So yeah. I've definitely had like, you know, I'm not a fan of the one night stand because I think I'm better the second time.
That's what I said.
Like, the second time be in the morning. Does it have to be?
That's fair. Mm. That's fair. But it's still the first time.
Okay.
All that still.
You mean
qualified.
The next time you see me?
Right.
The next time you see me
is okay. A beat. You.
Because I know what I'm dealing with.
Yeah,
I
know.
I done acquainted myself with some of your spots.
Right.
You know, I know your zones.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I know how to
you
get
know how
zone.
Far to push the legs back. Yeah, push it back too far, and they go, ah! Oh, my bad.
Oh, whoa. Well, I'm sure that happens to you all the time, because you get the more robust girls.
Fluffies, as like, he calls them fluffies.
The robust.
I've missed you, Rodney. I've missed
the thickums.
Yeah, the thick thickums. I like them on top.
Do you?
Mm-mm.
Not me.
Gotta have a lot of dick though, dude.
Well, you know, that's up for you. That's up for you, Speedy. I mean, it's rumors that it's not true.
It's hilarious.
Gotta have a long dick on the back. Otherwise, that ain't your position. Don't
sometimes
you
position,
know what they say about
positions,
guys,
you know, favor.
Every position ain't for everybody.
True. I completely agree.
Yeah, ain't
completely
fair,
agree. Completely agree.
Those niggas, you know.
I'm a strong medium myself. With a flare. With a flare.
With a flare. With a what?
With a flare. Because what
F-L-A-R-E?
It is, my penis kind of it kind of curve a bit. So, you know.
Your left or right hand?
Damn, Speedy, does that?
I'm usually looking at it in the mirror, so I'm going to say left.
Wow.
Can does we, going in the book ask about another dude's hook?
Like, yeah, right.
Or
which hand he uses to masturbate?
I said, okay, whatever. I ain't like.
Asked him what hand he uses to masturbate.
No, I did not.
No, he didn't. But for the record, I'm ambidextrous. If anybody,
that's not what I asked, no.
He asked which way it It lean.
Yeah.
When me and my right hand get into it, I go to my left hand.
Mm.
Okay.
We have arguments.
Not fucking with you no more.
Hey, how you doing?
You know what?
This bitch is tripping.
Yeah, you ever do that shit? And when you get done, you're like, why am I doing this?
Yeah, you feel
no,
like,
no,
I feel like
I completely enjoy myself.
Really?
You're happy every with
time,
yourself
after? Oh, every time.
Really? I'm not.
When my wife leaves.
Hilarious.
Hilarious.
It's showtime.
You put on your towel and
I got a whole lighting system. I
you like
in.
Candles? Put on music. Beautiful.
No candles. No candles. I like natural light. I like
that's Louis Dix style.
Hilarious.
Oh wow.
Louis Dix lights candles.
Fucking hilarious. Rodney Perry.
Louis Dix. How is he doing?
Yeah. Well, anyway, when do you actually tape tomorrow or today?
I taped yesterday.
He's doing fine. In
and
fact,
I shoot tomorrow.
Him and TDP have a show here tonight.
Oh, get out of here!
And for the fans of The Late Show, it now airs from 9 to 11 p.m.
Tonight. 9 to 11.
Yes.
Mm. So those used to be your guys, right?
Yeah. Oh, used
they
to
still
be.
Cool.
We still cool.
Oh,
they've been
they
on
just
the
doing,
show.
They're doing a different thing.
Doing their own thing.
Yeah, Louis ain't been here.
Louis has been here.
Louis
what
been
are you
on
talking
the show
about?
A couple times.
Wow. How was he doing? Because the last time I saw him, I was like, "Man, you all right?"
That nigga down, he down to about 122.
It don't look like no workout. It look like
no. Yeah. It look like he looked like the doctor said, "Take this."
Okay. All of it.
Yeah. That nigga go get an X-ray. He's holding up to the light.
Oh, you good?
You got a little spot on your liver, but you're good.
Yeah, you got a little papyrus. I can see straight through.
Oh, what?
Papyrus.
You look like papyrus.
All right, so we have a top five. You ain't going.
Oh, I forgot.
I'm here, baby.
You ain't got
I'm
shit here. To do. Why are you late, nigga?
I'm not late.
You knew
Paul
about this. We were here at 11.
Paul said we going from 11 to any time between there.
Nigga, why you didn't call me?
Because I talked to Portis. She in charge.
She don't know shit. Who in charge?
Ain't no lights without Portis.
I need you to gaze at
me. What it say? Morris Media.
Thank you.
So now you
thank
want,
you,
so
Rodney,
now you want
right?
Rodney to gaze at you.
Hold
I don't
on.
Know why
nigga,
it's so hard for Speedy.
It's Morris Media on that wall. You see what this wall says?
What does it say?
Do you see what it say?
Where's Speedy? Roll Live Radio
what
Show streaming live.
See that right there? What
does
that say?
On Morris Media. Morris Media comes first.
Morris Media.
I'm taking that part off.
Take it off. And.
Nigga, Speedy is behind the curtain.
So who is the N? Is that y'all?
Yeah, that's me.
Ignorant. I hate you.
I'm
love
a
you.
Friend.
Whatever, nigga.
Maybe.
Wait a second. Hold on, Speedy.
It's Ratio.
Yeah, Ratio.
It is now time for
top five.
Top five freaky things. Freaky questions.
Oh, okay.
Top five freaky. What is it?
Sexual relationship.
Oh, that was a
question.
Good word. Sexual ass.
Why are your shoulders move?
I wanted it to make me feel good.
All right.
This sounds amazing, too.
All right.
Bad.
So we have that's top we five things not to put up with in a relationship.
Mm. Mm. Top five things
that,
not to.
That ain't sexy.
Little youngsters, write this shit down.
Right.
Not to and put up with.
And some of you old niggas, too.
Okay.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Use a pencil so you don't lose it.
All right.
Yeah, don't use. Anyway. Number five.
Number five.
I know you hate this one. Unfriendly behavior. Arguing
yeah,
in front of
I don't
people.
Like, yeah, I don't like
arguing
bitches
in front
that,
of your
yeah.
friends.
Be nice
front,
to
don't yeah. embarrass me ever.
Yeah.
Don't get into an argument in front of your friends or whatever.
Don't
try
raise
to
your
front
voice.
You.
I had one girl was like, and I said, ooh. Bitch, no. We don't do that here. No, bitch, you ain't finna.
No, Speedy's thing is, we not gonna do that.
We not gonna do that.
That is Speedy's
thing. I will cut you off. We
then I'll be like, nigga, you ain't gonna tell me what we not gonna do.
We not gonna do that. And I will walk away.
Because women that turn up that way, it's really, if you attack them that way, they're gonna meet you with equal fervor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Fervor. Okay.
Good
okay.
word.
Word of the
I
day.
See you.
Fervor. Okay.
You. I see you. Uh-huh.
It's not a Chicago word, but anyway.
That's Chicago. It's a dictionary word, nigga.
But yeah, I can't.
People
I can't.
Who can read use fervor.
Wow. Well said.
No, you use Fiverr. Look here. well, I cannot
be regular.
I cannot stand a woman that wants to challenge me in public.
Agreed.
It's not going to happen.
Yeah.
Now,
I think
privately,
as a woman,
you accept the challenge?
No, you're not going to do it then.
Agree.
More so, privately than
no.
in public.
Yeah, I mean, you're going to argue with me
because I don't
private.
Argue. I don't
yeah.
argue. Private. We might have to go back and forth in a minute, and then I leave. Then who you going to argue with then?
For the women, though, what's like in a confrontation, like what's a no-no for a guy? I mean, is
looking
it
at another bitch in front of me?
Whoa, you need a hug, nigga? We're talking about something.
Come here.
No, we're talking about.
DJ Ron, come give her a hug. This is the bullshit, man.
Or some dick. Whatever.
Yeah, give her a needle.
You're not going to do it.
Yeah. You ain't going to stick. So what do you mean, like, look at another
damn.
Dude?
Well, I'm saying.
He can't look.
Not
look
disrespectfully.
Together.
Not
look
disrespectfully.
Together.
He can be like, God damn! Woo!
Yeah, exactly.
Look at that bitch ass. Psh,
hold up. We not going to do that, bitch. Don't hit me.
We not going to do
no,
that.
No, I think it goes the same. I wouldn't want a man loud talking me or embarrassing
absolutely
me.
Absolutely not.
Portis, remember when you was doing the thing and Disha said that to you on when you guys was hiking?
But so, it wasn't.
But you freaked out.
What happened?
No, me and my friend went hiking.
All the secrets.
And he was talking loud. He goes, "You hear that new DJ Quick bomb ass pussy?" Loud.
But that
loud
wasn't
in front of the people. That wasn't
was
like
he
was. That wasn't
no,
like him
I'm
cussing
about
me
when
out.
He said, "Just go hike with them," and you was like, "Oh,
oh." Oh. Oh yeah. We went hiking, and with some chicks walking in front of us, and he said, "Let's go ask them to hike with us."
And peace
he
out.
Was probably what? Completely honest. I mean, completely
he
platonic.
Was honest.
I mean, he probably wasn't
he
tripping
was
though.
Honest, but he probably didn't know he was thinking out loud.
This is the Rodney Perry I remember, because no matter what you say, he goes opposite of it. Well, maybe it's you. But no. I used to get on Rodney because no matter what I brought up, I said, after we show in, I said,
told my son
Rodney, you gotta agree with me on something. No, Speedy. I'm going to always go against
the radio
no.
is always conflict.
Fuck that. Agree with her.
Well done. You should hike more.
No, then he was saying, though. Hey, we should go ask them to hike with us. And I
said,
no.
Said, what?
What?
What we not going to do?
Yeah, so. Yeah,
you know. What you going to do is suck these titties.
Wow.
In my shoes.
These boots on. These hiking boots.
That would have been funny
Number four. I can't let no woman just. Yeah. Not
you shouldn't argue. If you're fucking with somebody, you shouldn't. United we stand, divided we fall. Like, we're not finna sit here and argue in front of people.
In a perfect
we're not gonna
world.
Do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, in a perfect world.
But we do argue.
You know, y'all,
at
my mom's house. And fuck your who?
I do not, I will
bitch.
Not.
Bitch.
I like the comfort.
I'll save it for the car.
Really?
Turn you on.
I think I like all that maniac crazy shit. I like
again,
it.
Again, goes back to what we said
crazy
earlier.
Pussy
crazy
wins.
Crazy pussy wins. Yeah. All right.
Number four. Number four.
If you are the only one who is sacrificing in the relationship.
Mm. Yeah, I hate that too.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like with me, it's always.
Well, Pam, you like young niggas and
they don't sacrifice.
No, they don't. sorry. They left their mama house to come live with you.
Speedy, what have you
come
sacrificed?
Come on, mama too.
Oh, no, in a relationship,
I'm always mama too.
You're single.
Just so you understand, I'm a great boyfriend when I was doing that.
What have you sacrificed in your relationship?
Yeah, what do you sacrifice?
I want to know.
That you with me.
So basically you have nothing to offer.
So you sacrificed that a bitch settled.
Oh.
What we not gonna do. Embarrass me.
Yeah, we ain't gonna embarrass
in front of Rodney. This nigga just got here. Now in front of the little Chicago, you can do that. My nigga here Rodney. Nah.
Well, that is awkward.
Now what do you mean by
what's going on?
Ain't you the host?
No.
You do say Speedy at the bottom. On the right hand side.
She's
a curve. It curved to the right. Yeah.
She the end.
I'm
we
a friend.
The ends.
You're a friend.
I'm the end. You the friend.
I'm a friend.
I'm you the S. You the S.
I'm the S.
Okay, well, nigga.
Well, you the period.
Well, it's my last day.
Is it?
So I got all the questions.
So.
Now, what do you mean by whatever?
Sacrifice?
No.
What is
sacrifice?
Say again, number four.
You're the only one who sacrifices in a relationship.
And making more the effort. Like,
yes.
Yeah,
making the plan.
Like,
asking out.
Yeah.
That's me trying to plan what we going to do, cooking, all the time.
Women do that.
No, I mean, but sometimes you want it done too.
But Pam, the guys you date are too young to even.
We're not talking about me.
They're 15.
I don't even think it's an age thing.
We're just talking about
for her.
I'm a caretaker. I know this. And I'm trying to, you know. And then, too, you always get the guy, too, that's always like, oh, you're in the business. Can you help me? No, nigga, no.
But you would help somebody you were intimate with. You were in a relationship with.
Absolutely.
You know, I think this. First of all, people are terribly consistent.
Mm-hmm.
So when you expect people to do something that they don't do, you the damn fool.
Mm.
People very seldom act outside of themselves. Very seldom. Mm.
True.
You know,
right. Once somebody shows you who they are, believe them.
I don't. To be honest, like listen to this question. I make very little adjustments. What's the word?
Sacrifices.
I make very little sacrifices.
You do,
but
you're married.
I make a lot of
sacrifices
though. At the same time, like it's some stuff I just don't compromise on.
Oh, okay.
I don't let my wife can't. She don't have no input on my comedy. You know, like I had comics.
Oh,
I had
oh
comics like, yo,
God.
Man, you know, my wife don't want me to do that joke. I'm like,
I'm dealing with that shit right now. And I said, first of all, when you gonna do? I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna do the way I've been doing it. It's been working for me. Mm-hmm. You knew what show you told has worked.
Hold on, she may have a point.
Hashtag shade.
Right.
What we not gonna do.
Nigga,
I gotta stand up. Nigga to the left.
You make me stand up the rest of the
show. But they do that. Women, and they just wanna chime in on shit. I'm like, well, why don't you?
Really? Rodney, stop. Has your wife tried to tell you what to do with your comedy?
She has given some input over the years. I mean, it'll be 20 years this year.
Oh wow.
So,
okay.
You know, we'll be married 20 years this year. So, yeah, this is the best advice she ever gave me. Because, you know, back in the day, I was in the Bay Area doing comedy. And at the end of the show, we would drink. They would set the bar out. We'd all drink and kick it. Mm-hmm. And I would come home, like, super drunk or whatever. And she's like, where you been? I'm like, I'm taking care of business. Don't ask me that. I'm taking care of it. She said, how you taking care of business and you drunk?
Oh.
Look, where the money? Oh, shit. I forgot to get it. They paid me in Crown Royal.
Yeah, man. I didn't realize I was paying for that.
Took change. My bad, baby. You have a point. You got it. You know what?
And to this day, I'm really, you know, conscious of like, my public look.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, being intoxicated around people. You very rarely catch me that way.
Because Rodney, when he drunk, it's fun.
Is it?
It's absolutely fucking hilarious.
It's a good fucking time.
It's absolutely hilarious.
Oh, yeah.
Number three.
Surveillance. If a dude is internet stalking you or just stalking you, period, like, why you got to go there? Why you do it? What were you doing there? Calling you 20 times a day. And
dudes do that?
Yes. That's the new way, especially internet stalking.
Well, women try to be slick. They go, they'll turn their phone off and put another one and go, oh, shit, let me use your phone. No, bitch, no. No.
Let me go get your phone.
No, bitch.
I got your phone right here. I know that you had left another room.
I want to check my Facebook. No, my I just throw myself out the window. It don't work.
It don't work. Break it in half. Break it on your knee.
You don't want to use that shit. And then I put a, because when I first.
That can't be a deal breaker for a guy, though. Because women do that.
Surveillance?
Yeah, but I didn't know
women
that.
Women do that.
When you, like, we were together and I didn't have the screen, you know, they had
the
that
protective,
little,
yeah. Where you get no angles.
No, where you can't get no angles.
Yeah.
And I just wasn't paying attention. I'm in the car texting. She said, And she had saw me texting. And later on, she's like, so who the bitch you was texting? I said, how you know?
Like
that. You ain't gonna know tomorrow. Go to Big Lot. I need that screen thing.
I tell you what.
So the next time she looks, she's like, "What's wrong with your phone?" I'm like, "What do you mean?"
Can't see
shit. Because
you're supposed to do surveillance.
You got me right here to see this motherfucker.
You're supposed to do surveillance where they don't know. Yeah. Like I know all the codes, all the everything, but you.
But why do you need
know.
To know that? Why do you need to know anything about my phone? You don't pay the bill on it. But you ain't paying the bill on it. But you don't pay the bill on my phone.
That's fine. I'm not going to ask you. It's not a requirement of our relationship, but just the...
Know that I know.
Skill of observation. Nigga, if it has to go down, and I'm not a scroller, now, so I'm not going to go through everything.
What about internet stalking?
For sure, but I ain't going to like nothing. I'm not going to like nothing. I'm not going to comment. I'm not going to say who's the bitch in the picture. None of that.
See,
but I know, and I hold
on. You're making
on
a mental note.
That's one thing I don't do. I will say, I know it's hard to believe, I don't do some shit.
You
but
army crawled under the bed. Nigga, you don't check a nigga's Facebook?
Yeah, army crawled under the bed and checked the nigga's phone.
No, I stopped doing that.
All he saw was a hand.
A high bed.
Look, nigga, all he saw was this.
What?
And she's still in the bed. Her arm came under the eye and got the nigga phone. And she said, she looked and went, I know what the code is. I don't know how women do it.
Oh, I got a whole 20 minutes on the whole concept.
I don't know how they do it.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, all you got to do is...
If I use their thumb to open and I go to the bathroom and I spend the whole time...
But how do you get their thumb? While they sleep?
Yeah.
I don't sleep that hard. You grab... You.
I hold your hand like you're holding my hand.
Yeah.
We just cuddling and I'm using...
Mm-hmm. You just do this. That's brilliant.
I will not.
Can
we put her out?
Yeah, we need to put her out. She's giving too much info.
I don't like it.
Because I think when you... And most dudes, I guess, they sleep really hard. I don't sleep that hard. You grab my hand, I think we finna fuck. Hey, wake up.
Uh-huh.
You ain't finna roll my hand on the thing and then open the world. Yeah, you ain't gonna just thumbprint me.
Well, this is what you gotta wrap
up. I don't sleep like that.
Wake up with black stuff on your tongue.
Hey, bitch, what you been doing?
Women know stuff that we just don't know. Like, if you're in any type of relationship, your woman probably knows your social.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Any
car driver's license. I
absolutely.
Definitely get a copy.
I'm willing to bet you that.
I've known.
I
all
do.
Of them.
I get a copy. Yeah.
I'm willing to
but
bet you that.
I haven't known all of them because I actually sought it out. Like, I didn't ask for it.
It just kind of happened.
Yeah. Like, if we're doing something like, oh, okay, well, here's the.
I know your last four, and that leads to the other two, and that leads to the other three. Boom.
Yeah, it ain't hard.
Number two.
Yeah.
Stalking ass.
Number two. If he had a label allergy. Huh? That means he don't claim you, or he can't say, "Oh, this is my girl. This is my," and you've been fucking the fucking allergy. Wow,
that's funny.
That is the amazing nice way to put that.
Yeah, it is, right?
You walk basically, up. Yeah, this.
Well, you know, we kind of been.
Yeah, if he can't introduce her mom, you to his family,
her mom and my mom are friends.
She know Portis.
She know Portis.
Does that help, bitch?
Well, not at all.
Wow.
That's
a typical.
But why
that's
are
a guy
okay?
Thing.
Let
that's
me
a guy
ask
thing.
This:
that's a guy thing.
Why are labels important though? If the relationship
for a woman,
is going good,
it is for me.
For women, it is. Guys, we don't give a fuck.
I think
no,
it just needs. I think women just need clarity.
Yeah. Well, okay.
Labels are important because I am the queen of not having labels. And okay. I'm like, okay, we're grown-ups. We're doing everything that you do in a relationship. Mm-hmm. And then when this nigga is fucking half of California, it's like, well, we weren't really together. Nigga,
we was we, just... You, we, I just
they can say you... They
ass,
can
sir.
Give you...
Wow.
We just, no.
I was really going to say Thanksgiving.
You went home for Christmas. You went home for Christmas. We together, nigga.
Just because that, you that, have that the, a label does not mean that nigga's not going to do what he gonna
that's
do.
True.
I agree with you but wholeheartedly, least, but the label gives you
it gives
the
you nothing
to some, say something.
Yeah,
because if I'm like, nigga, how you fucking everybody? We together, not
niggas will give you labels. They'll say you they girl. They even marry you and still do what they want to do.
Very
agreed.
True. Very true.
So
agreed,
it's
but,
like we can't get caught up in oh that's my boyfriend. It's
so,
all
so,
about
so
how the
why
it's
not,
all
though?
About the
why,
respect.
Why can't we get caught up in that?
Yeah,
because
we should.
I just think that it just complicates things if the relationship.
So
it's
a
cool.
Dude, everybody needs labels.
You with a dude for
I
you.
Think,
yeah, I think so.
If your relationship is good, you don't even have to
hold
say
on,
that we have
some shit
a man has successfully brainwashed you.
Hold what? On, Portis. You with a dude for a year. Y'all fucking whenever
right.
you fuck.
You,
you
do
with
a
for
Thanksgiving
a year.
Together,
when,
going
when
on
you
his
go
family.
Somewhere and me
and
Rodney are there.
And then he texts me and tell
no,
me
no.
it's over.
He,
that's what you gonna do?
Oh, wow.
That's what you gonna do? This turned into me.
Just slapped you right in your face. So anyway, who breaks up over a text?
The only real label I had.
Her man.
I was just playing.
Really?
Let me get you caught up. So her man, she was getting dressed for to go out with him.
Yeah. No,
said,
that's not
bitch
what
is
happened.
Over.
That's not. That's
and,
not
and
how
threw the
it
phone
happened.
Out the window.
That's
no,
not
he didn't.
How
yeah,
it
yeah bitch is over. Then he said bitch right.
That's how you.
How you spell it?
B C T H.
No vowels.
I-E.
I-E.
Hey bitches. No, P. I'm asking you. You were a dude for a year.
That hurts.
Y'all kind of fuck a little bit, whatever. Me and Rodney walk
kind
up.
Of
and
fuck a little bit.
I'm just saying. And me and Rodney walk up, and the dude go, "Oh, that's Portis." You not like?
Yeah,
that's all
I'm
I
going.
Am?
Yeah.
You not like this? He, oh, and he don't say you a girl. He just go.
I just
that's
feel
my girl.
Like
what's acceptable? Is, oh, that's my bae. This is bae.
When you're ooh. With a man that loves and wants to be with you,
he'll
there's
show
no
that.
Question yeah. about what it is.
No, I'm saying. No,
there
but,
is a question because
no,
he will
question.
Claim you and say, this is my chick. We
my
together.
Girl.
This is me and you. I don't want anybody else.
I just don't
else.
Agree with what everybody
one on
agrees
one.
With.
Yes, it's
so,
you
so
and
y'all
period.
Point is it needs to be public.
Yes.
Not public.
I want mine. Yes.
Whatever.
Yes.
Whatever. We don't have to change Facebook statuses. We don't have to do that. But we need to have an agreement.
And we need
if
to get
me
caught
and you
over
were together.
Let me know when you're ready. I'm ready. Flag football. He dated a nigga that plays flag football on Sundays.
Look at him. No. I like flag football.
No, he did. at the park.
Aww. Does Horatio like flag football?
Well, you know, I used to play many years ago. And Speedy would be out there. And I was like, Speedy, I don't have the ball. You're chasing me again.
Stupid. Are you chasing you without the ball?
Fucking hilarious.
I don't have it again. You tackled me.
Oh, my God.
It's touch, flex. Speedy.
Number.
Oh, my God.
Number one.
There's some more numbers.
Hilarious. Wait a minute. I can't read my own writing.
It's number one.
Well, that was number
one. Was
oh.
that two?
I thought we were at three.
That was two.
We're on two now.
Wait,
we're on
right?
two
oh,
now,
yeah,
right?
Oh, no,
God.
I lost
it. Oh, insult you in public. No, insult you,
which
period.
One number is this? So
number one. I'm okay. Sorry. Insult you. Like, well, damn, bitch, you looking, you know, you too fat, but then say, oh, I'm just kidding. Like, basically, mentally abuse you. Mentally. Yeah, you know what I'm
we're
saying?
We're not going to do that.
Yeah, like, you know what I'm saying?
That's unacceptable.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, you going to eat that last piece of...
I know you about to hit that gym. No, you right. ain't.
I'm just kidding. Insult you. That's what I wrote. I
dress like all of you look fat.
He can't take it back? Yeah. He can't take it back?
No, in general, no. Too no. many jokes. I know you guys are comedians.
Too many jokes.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, that's not going to work.
But you got to always yeah. be. You should be the encouraging factor.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's yeah, all I'm absolutely. Saying. Yes.
You come out dressed, he go, when you get dressed?
Right.
Oh, you wearing that? Uh-huh. And ain't no LL behind it.
Yeah.
but sometimes your woman will ask you, like, you're honest, what do you think for real? They never mean that.
No.
Hey, babe, for real, what do you think? And that shit looks
amazing. Don't ever fall into the trap, fellas, of going real with it. Just go, no, you look nice. It look cool.
I like it.
No, seriously, tell me if I look fat. Mm-mm. Don't just stay.
But I will get excited. Like, my wife, she'll go, like, put on one pair of shoes. Oh, no, those are cool. You're like, oh, I'll be right back. Because she know that the cool ain't the real answer.
Because she know you have to.
Because I get excited when it's, like, really dope. I'm like, now, that's dope.
Now, mine's just opposite.
Yeah.
If I say I like it, she don't like it. So I go, I don't like those. And I know she's going to keep
it. She's going to wear that.
Yeah. Really?
Wow. Yeah, that means she don't trust your opinion.
Yeah, pretty much.
Which is smart.
First of all,
I don't like her not trusting your opinion. Just throwing it out there.
No, I just understand that she just goes against whatever.
It's, no, like, okay. It's contradictory.
Yep.
What's her sign?
Look, nigga, you don't know.
It's on my phone.
Nigga, it should be when, so quick.
When's her birthday?
I didn't know my wife's birthday for like 3 years.
Hold on, she I need had to a use tattoo my tongue.
She has her birthday tattooed on her.
Yeah, she had it on her thigh. She had a tattoo on her thigh. And so I would have to, one, wait for her to wear some shorts.
Hilarious. And two, I let you know the birthday is the next day. Oh, she showed me.
Oh, Lord, shit. Jesus.
December 25th.
Yeah,
damn.
But that was years ago. No, now.
No, June 19th.
Okay. It's Cancer.
No, I'm sorry, not June. May 19th.
Wow.
Taurus
the Bull.
The end of the
but
that, Taurus.
That's a love match for you, though. Taurus the Bull and Virgo. Absolutely. That's a love match. Mm.
Look here, Serpico.
Serpico? What does that mean? What are you talking about? I mean, I know my astrology. I've been around.
Hilarious.
In Palm, baby.
I like Taurus. They're cool.
They're a little mean. They're a little mean.
Until you get a man.
They mean people. Yeah.
Leo's are mean people.
Whoa.
Leo's
I like
mean.
The lion.
My sister Leo.
To my mom, my best friends.
They're the meanest motherfuckers in the world.
I am not
they
mean.
Loyal, but they mean
I'm
as
not
fuck.
Mean.
Leo's are mean. Great.
Yeah, I should have known that. That's why we get along. Yep.
When is yours?
Sag. I'm Sagittarius.
Oh, y'all good
big
folks.
Stone freak.
A little nasty. Yeah, nasty little Sagittarius.
We are.
Stone cold freak.
That's why she's up for everything.
That's why little young niggas love her.
Sagittarius be up for shit you not up for. Like,
you want to swing from here?
No, I can't do that.
You want me to put my dick in the vice?
No, I'll squeeze it. I won't do it hard.
You ain't going to do it hard.
That's very true, though.
Oh, they have offered to shave your shit. I'll shave no, bitch.
I just
not
going to
put no clippers by my shit, not you.
Get clean.
And right there, they hold you. Said, "So who's the bitch that came over the other day?"
Nobody.
She breaks out the scissors.
Hilarious.
That was Pam's top five right there.
Mm-hmm. Top five.
Top five. In the celebrity birthday news, we'll go there right now. Happy birthday to Shy Jackson, the young lady. For those who don't know, on the little show, if you have kids, Jesse.
Oh, we don't have kids, so
my daughter.
I have
she's
children,
and she's 14. She only.
What's the name of the show? Jesse.
Yeah, it's a show. Jesse.
It's like a teenage show.
Yeah, it's on Disney Channel.
Oh, got it. Yeah.
Now she has like another show.
My baby is six, so my other
she knows.
Passed that.
They know. They may know. And also, happy birthday to Biz Markie.
Happy
birthday. And
I like
Biz
Markie. 52. He's a nice guy, man.
He's cool as fuck.
He's
but
52?
does he have 52. To be nice, though?
Yeah, look at him.
Yeah.
He's a hard sell.
Hard sell?
He's a hard sell, man.
We was on Tom Joyner with him before. And he
yes.
Was, oh, yeah. We're on. Yeah. You were there, too. That's for all was. Of us. That's yeah. Right.
We'll talk
fun.
Later. Would you fuck Biz?
No.
Oh, God.
No.
For no reason.
No.
For no reason.
Oh, my God.
You know what Biz is?
Nice
Biz
guy,
is
no.
Rich.
Yes, he is.
You know Biz is very rich. Biz is Yo Gabba Gabba.
Gabba,
Yo Gabba. The TV show. The TV show, Yo Gabba Gabba.
Right. He's a voice on,
his, no, it's not a voice. It's his show.
Oh, it is?
It's his whole concept.
Biz, oh, wow, I didn't
he
know
owns
that.
Yo Gabba Gabba.
That's dope.
Wow,
he told me.
That.
Biz is breath on fire, too.
Are these ladies...
yeah, they're voicing their opinion.
Chiming in.
Yeah, Portis, would you
no,
fuck...
No, Biz.
You're a rapper. Would you fuck Biz?
No, I would not.
No, this thing, that, I don't believe that.
I don't believe it.
Don't
B.O.
believe no woman.
He has B.O.
Yeah, he does.
He has a slight little twang to him. You're absolutely right.
Yeah.
He got a little ordeer.
Halitosis ordeer. Going on.
Yeah, but you know, you can fix. You can rip one tooth out
no.
and fix that. I'm telling you, Now, women are optimists. Women can find the beauty in some women can find the beauty in any
we
guy.
We can.
But they're not there. It's a hard sell for real.
Now, in one of your question things, let me ask the ladies this. Mm-hmm. You're dating a guy, you like him, everything's going good. Mm-hmm. Maybe got halitosis. Do you tell him?
Oh, I've tried that.
Go on and brush your teeth, or do you just let it roll out?
Go on and brush your teeth,
or do you go brush your teeth thinking he coming there?
I couldn't kiss you.
It's the worst.
No, would you tell him?
That's medical. She said that's medical.
But no. The question is, would you tell him?
I think I would.
I
got
to go to the dentist today.
I can't do smells. I don't like funky stuff.
I don't like smells either. Like I don't like no medicine. I'm scared to tell him. No medicine it smells.
Yeah.
I just had this girl years ago, and we was kicking it, you know, and I was like, whoa.
Medication, bitch.
Medicine. Amoxicillin?
Amoxicillin.
She has antibiotics.
Why you got... Are you sick?
Cotton, you got cotton in your ears?
What's wrong with you?
No.
Fucking
no, because I dated this girl who was a dime piece.
Mm-hmm. Stinky.
That bitch would go to sleep. And her...
was it her breath?
Yeah, it would smell like zoo dirt. Like
was that. It the night time like? Or just morning breath?
Zoo dirt.
No, mine was all the time.
It smelled,
the time
I'm sorry, it smelled like boo boo.
Yeah.
And I would play it off and I'd go, let me do me. Maybe the bitch would come in the bathroom with me and I'd leave the door open. Hey, what are you doing, baby? You're good. Hey, your toothbrush right here.
brush your tongue extra hard. Look, you got to hit that tongue.
Right. Bitch, swallow your toothbrush. Shit. But I always found it hard to tell.
Because she was gorgeous.
It's a very hard thing.
Even just friends, you can't. It's hard to tell somebody they got halitosis.
But what if you're a supervisor? Because sometimes as a boss, you got to make that. You got to make that call.
That's true.
You know, I mean, if you people it's fall under you, like, yo, come have a seat, though.
Or what I've about okay? What before. About the dudes that be funky, and you go get in the shower, and he be like, "Nah, I'm cool." Like, God.
I would
pick the woman up and put her in the shower.
I definitely would, nigga. Your balls stink.
As soon as you take my,
but you can laugh at that. You can be like, you know, I'm just serious.
No.
No, seriously.
Get your ass in the shower.
Well, balls is surface. You can easily dust off some balls. That's your job.
What?
The woman.
No.
To dust these balls.
No, hilarious.
You got to suggest it sexy.
So you would,
get in the shower together.
And he says, no, I'm cool.
Nigga, no, you're not.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You got to hit this towel. Yeah. I want to clean it myself.
We're going to
go with Virgos, you know.
But again, that's surface. That's easy. That's you came from the gym.
But some people don't do that.
Halitosis is
you
hard. You
got to walk away from the situation. Mm-hmm. You got to be like, nigga, we ain't going to make it.
Right. Wow.
Yeah, because I like to kiss.
It could be a bad day. Yeah.
No.
Halitosis isn't a bad day.
No, because if it's more than one day, you know. Like
Y'all not doctors. Y'all can't make a diagnosis on halitosis.
But you know if somebody, smells like garlic pasta, or if they smell like yesterday.
Right. Like doo doo.
Know the difference.
Yeah, when I smell boo boo, I guess this bitch didn't want to kiss me. Shit.
You. Mm-hmm. So you kissed her, mm-hmm. and
mm-mm, mm-mm. I'm all inside your face. Mm-hmm.
You the shit, bitch.
Literally. Hey, boo boo.
Hey.
Why you keep calling me boo boo?
Cartoon.
It's a cartoon.
I'm Yogi. You're boo boo.
Oh, that's funny. We gonna call each other that? Yes, bitch.
He gave us
cute little nickname. He's Yogi.
I'm boo boo.
Yeah, our friends be like, that's a good name. It fits.
It's time to go.
I always wondered about that. And then, so today, did you tell a story about the guy you were dating? Or
really?
And he lost his leg. Like, so now he sells shoe.
He's a shoe?
He used to be a shoe salesman. Now he just sells shoe. At that left shoe.
We don't have the right one. I was going to date, and we really didn't quite make it for whatever reason. I thought something was off about him. But anyway... my friend was on the phone and he was like, well, you know, I lost my leg. And
go get it.
Really?
Like, you just woke up like, I don't
know. Right.
Looking for my dad.
And she was like, no, this is, I don't want to say no names. And she called me. She's like, girl. I was like, what? She said, such and such lost his leg. I said, shut up. And I was like, why? Because of diabetes? Yeah, pretty much. Wow. But I was just like, I said, what was the
But you don't just lose a leg. I mean, you lose a toe. You lose a foot.
Yeah.
You know, it builds up.
So now he has a job.
Well, so now he's selling stuff on Crenshaw.
Ask me what the business is called.
What's the business called?
Hip hop.
See, that wasn't funny.
Hip hop is the name of the business of a guy with one foot.
Oh my God.
That's what he got. A
hip. Your love for Hoppy.
Oh wow. Now
could you stay with somebody that lost a limb?
That's like, sickness in the hell, rich limb? Or poor. That's
okay, no, I'm just a girlfriend. No,
could
boyfriend.
You? What limb? Girlfriend, boyfriend. Like, he girlfriend, lost his boyfriend. Whole leg, nigga.
First of all, let's really look at the girlfriend the boyfriend. Physicality of it. Okay.
Do they have labels?
First of all, whatever his penis was, it's probably going to give him another 2 or 3 inches.
Without a leg, though?
You are so wrong for that.
Fuck you up.
And if it's a girl, the access to the vagina is
much easier.
Primo.
Yeah.
Hard to say no. Bitch, I don't need the other leg.
Let me get some of that leg.
Let my leg go.
I did a comedy club in Greensboro, South Carolina, and the chef... I can't see. Well, when you on stage, you can look back into the kitchen almost. And so I see this dude, just his body going back and forth. This nigga came out and stood in the doorway. He had one leg. So you look up and you see this.
I don't know.
He's leaning.
Leaning.
Yeah,
man. He had one leg, but he was killing the kitchen, the cooking game, and I'm sure he had a woman in his life because he's a chef.
So again, shallow ladies.
Security.
Ron got it. Would you date someone who lost a limb?
That's not what you asked. You said if we were together and he lost the
limb. And he lost a limb.
You would stay with him.
I would stay because that's what women do.
Whoa.
But I'm not going to meet
you. I don't like your stay.
With no legs.
Yeah.
Oh, so you wouldn't. So a dude with one leg can't come at you like, hey.
If I met you with one leg, I don't know.
I mean, he's handsome.
I just said I don't know.
Like, and he was seated. He was like in a chair, so you didn't know at first.
I got to be in a situation.
And he charmed you for weeks over the phone.
I got to be in a
situation. Or you met him online.
Got to be. I don't know.
No.
You should have told me up front. I don't
feel
like pushing nobody around.
Hilarious. You guys are so shallow.
Wow.
No,
Pam?
I just said I don't know.
You meet the dude. He got one on.
I don't know his no.
Well, at 27, maybe. At 35, I'm like, nigga, we might have a chance.
Oh, man. Let me see your trunk.
Right.
You see what leg is still working.
Right. Still in baby-making years.
You got to think, too, also, he probably got way more access to blood because he ain't wasting no leg blood.
Really?
I'm done.
You're so wrong.
I am done. Done.
In theory, he's actually right.
I'm throwing it out there. Like, come on, stay with me on this.
No.
The reason why I asked, and we talked about this a long time ago, someone introduced me to somebody, and dying piece came over my Beautiful. House. I'm thinking.
Rolled over, head, rolled by.
And she's sitting on the couch, and her hands were like fucked up. And I went, ooh, damn, it's getting late. Well, your kids are
Both
coming
her
over.
Hands?
No, just one.
Come on, you can.
No, couldn't do it.
One hand? And was
what
it
was
left?
Wrong with this?
Was it her left hand?
What was wrong with her?
It was like...
Was she a lefty?
It was all burnt up.
It was burnt.
Mm-hmm.
So it was visually unappealing mm-hmm. as well.
And it was burnt to the little like this. And then, so
don't touch me with the hand.
So it was one of these. And I didn't notice it when she came over, when she sat on the couch.
I don't like people that have the little claw and don't tell you.
How do you tell somebody? No, excuse me, I got a claw.
Not excuse me, I have a claw, but they use it. They like use it to shake hands with and stuff. And I'm like, dude, you gotta notify me. You gotta give me one of these up here before you shake my hand with the claw.
And so the girl was in my house, and I wanted to hit so bad. She was my flavor,
God.
Big old thickums.
Yeah.
And I didn't see the hand until that time, and right. I went, ooh. Mm. Yeah, it's good. She's like, well, you want me to stay? It's late. It's late? It's late.
Yeah.
It was like 7.
It was 7? I got to get up early.
I get up. Rodney and Ron got some shit.
Have you ever made a reservation for somebody and then their attitude was stink?
Mm.
You know what I mean? You're like, you know what? I normally don't mess with girls that look like you, but.
Oh, damn.
And then you find out. Like, I got to give you the story. So. Me and my boy, he had this one chick. He said, Roddy, just ride with me. You know, just occupy a friend. But I'm like,
take
whatever.
One.
I'm the life of the party.
Yeah, you're going to take one for
It's cool. So we talking. And I'm looking at her. I'm like, she got a kind of okay attitude, but it's like not cool.
She's being a little funky.
A little funky. And then as I'm like, wow, I'm looking at her. And I'm like, she had a keloid.
Oh, yeah, those are nasty.
It would look like, I thought she had earrings on. She had a little meat earring and had a nerve, the audacity.
Wait, a meat earring?
She had the audacity to have a bad attitude.
And you said.
Uh-oh.
I'm gonna fuck you this one time.
As I hold on to your meat earring.
Ha! Ha! Bitch, puss is coming out of this.
Oh. I'm sorry, I think I held it too hard. I'm sorry.
I hate so now, far. I can't do, I'll tell you what I cannot do.
What you won't do?
I will not do a woman with a just a weave I can see. Or the, when they do the lace front and they got that little line.
I don't like that line. I don't like that line.
Because I like to run my fingers through your hair. I just do. That's my get down.
That's one of your moves.
That's the move they go, ooh, that feel great. Yeah, but that's what I do.
That's why he likes them white.
But everybody got weed.
What in the
fuck? Oh, sorry.
My bad. I forgot my mic.
Bro, what's this? No,
damn.
I like to run my fingers through your hair.
So but not, is it true, Speedy?
But no. You know she had a weave.
No, I didn't. This
she,
one year later.
You didn't know it was a lace front.
I didn't know it was a lace front or a weave. And then I did
what
my.
What did you think it was?
I did my little move and it stopped. I went, ooh,
okay,
shit.
Okay.
Yeah, it's getting late.
So that's going to turn you
ladies,
off, really?
I can't ladies, they can't
you.
Hear you, but not hear
I know,
you.
Yeah. Can y'all keep it down?
But I like it, though. Saying. It's fun. I don't like weaves. Just don't.
Wow, really? That's interesting.
No I lace back.
That's beautiful.
No weave.
Fuck you.
That's an escrow going bad.
It didn't take. Damn.
The ends didn't.
This
take.
Is what we. Really? This is sponge, nigga.
Sponge, nigga, square pants.
White. Now, was a guy's
what's
with a curl?
Breaker? What's like, a deal breaker? Deals? What's a deal guys breaker? A
for aesthetics?
Yeah. Yeah.
Teeth. Oh. Fucked up teeth. I can't okay. do it. I cannot. You, yeah.
Somebody
your,
raise
your
a
mouth got to be right. Your mouth got to be right.
P? I mean, yeah, Pam.
Aesthetically. Oh God, that's a tough one.
It's tough.
This ain't no you take game show, motherfucker. You're like,
well, I don't want to be shallow, but
yeah, but go ahead.
That's the what we doing.
Yeah, small dicks.
Yeah,
dicks.
Car
you can't see a dick from across the street.
Yeah, but eventually she's gonna see.
Yeah, I'm gonna see it, and then
that's over. It's over. It's a wrap.
It's like
I don't give a fuck about your Bentley. What's this car charger you got?
Is there a penis too big for you?
Yes. I've ran for one before.
You ran?
Yes, I did. I was, oh, shit.
Ma'am, get back here!
Oh, no.
How cool. Hey, bitch, I can shorten it. Let me fold this in half.
But I like lips. I love a guy with nice lips. Mm. Nice big lips.
Why are you looking at me?
I didn't look at you.
You did.
Why are you raising your voice?
She did go way up. You couldn't even hear it.
Yeah. Are you shallow? Who are you, Virgo?
I mean, I got all type of pet peeves. Yeah. If I can, the only way I can stay married this long is I can find something wrong with anybody. Mm. I can literally, I mean, like, oh, look at her foot, though.
Look at her foot.
I had a bitch.
Club toe?
In my mind, I'd be like, I bet she stink. You know, I say
right.
stuff like that.
Right. I had a bitch was so fine. And she took her shoes. She used to never take her shoes off around me. She took them off at the house. And big toe. This toe here was about that big.
Wow.
It and was shorter than see, the rest?
It was really like,
oh, it was like
how you pull
a deformity.
It back? How you pull
yeah.
it back?
Like a little turtle. It was a turtle head, and I went, ooh.
It was like if she was a producer, that knob would be further yeah. back.
She'd have turned me down. So I said, we got to get you some socks, big. And it
you ain't breaking up with her.
I fucked a couple more times.
I know you did fuck. I know
but
you did.
Keep
she
your socks.
Keep her shoes
keep
on.
Your shoes
like,
on, bitch.
If I notice that, that's the foot I'm putting in my mouth.
Oh, my
really?
God.
I know nobody pay attention to it. I'm going for that. I'm giving her some attention.
We're looking at you like, what?
Yeah, I'm giving that little limb some love. Because I know it never get it.
Yeah.
People pass on it. And she's like, you know what? Nobody's ever done that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Like, you know.
Really?
That type of guy.
I guess that's
stupid. So you held on to the earlobes then, huh?
Yeah. Watch out. Ha! No, we don't.
Fuck one for the team. Sometimes you got to take one for the team.
I've done it a couple times.
Ron, I know you took one for the team. You went to Linwood.
Do girls do that?
No, girls, girls don't. They too picky
least
about
likely,
team.
Yeah.
Yeah, they least likely to take one for the
yeah,
team.
Yeah, I think so.
But you, I mean, if your girl was like, hey,
they'll sit in the room
go
and talk
out
to
with
her
blah, 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 you a go, you ain't got to do nothing. No? Yeah. Oh, man.
Because if you go, then you're that bitch who's just going for like a free meal or something. I'm like, I'm cool. I'm not.
So you gonna leave your girl hanging?
Yeah.
Nigga, call me when you make it.
Wow.
Like, text me and make sure you're safe.
That is so bad. How many times you took one for a friend?
Every single time.
I mean, how many in your life you think?
A lot. Sometimes I fucked a bitch. Shit. Like, how long are we going to be like, yo, we going to the girl house?
Your boy will tell you, though, you ain't got to do nothing.
Like, yeah. And then they go, what she look like? She cool.
God damn. All right. No, she ain't cool.
You get there, and then they in the room banging the fucking walls out. She looking at you like, so what else do you do beside comedy? That's it, bitch. Just tell jokes.
Wow.
You want fucking that?
That's it?
That's why we're here. You want fucking that? You want this dick?
Okay. Real quick story. So, I'm ex-Navy. You know Harry's my roommate.
Yes.
In the Navy.
Yeah.
So one of my other boys is like, man, right, can this girl come in your room? You know, because I got, you know, me and a girl going upstairs. I'm like, all right, man. So she comes. She's a little round. Little short.
Turn speedy on. Uh-huh.
She wasn't cute. So she not speedy type.
Well, yeah, speedy always says you got to have the cute in there.
You got to have
right,
some
with
cute.
The fluff.
You got to have some cute.
With the fluff.
So long story short, we end up doing it. Mm-hmm. So when we started, Harry wasn't home. So, you know, through the course of the whatever, he came in, mm-hmm. unbeknownst to me. So I'm walking her out, and I'm like, she's like, I swear this is her voice. She said, you going to call me?
Oh.
I said, yeah, I'm going to call you. Yeah. So I picked up what looked like a pen. She said, that ain't no pen. That's a toothbrush.
Oh. Bitch, if I wet the tip, it turns into a pen. See, you don't know shit.
So when we walk past Harry bed, she casts a shadow on the wall. And I see Harry look up like, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm sorry.
Take one for the team.
For the team.
He's like, he's did you write the number down?
I did not. I just hopefully it's not no little round Rodney somewhere. But Luxie,
I ain't seen my daddy in so long.
My mama say that's him on TV.
But I don't know for sure because I ain't wrote his name down.
Rodney Perry in the building.
Right with a toothbrush.
I came with y'all.
You're performing tonight, right, Rodney?
I am at the J Spot tonight right here in LA.
You know they got strippers now.
I heard. It's late, though.
Who heard it to the bitch?
It's late. Did the bitch come back? What voice was that?
Yeah.
No, what tripped me out is when she told me, I'm like, y'all, is it that bad?
Hey, nigga.
Yeah.
No.
The Empire thing with Kente's on.
And you know what kind of strippers?
Yeah, so I'm up early.
Yeah, that's tonight.
I'm up early. You know what kind of strippers? I'll be long gone by the time the strippers get
there. It's the strippers that you go, oh, they
can't. You go impossible.
Yeah.
You go impossible.
And these are niggas that probably got fired at other places, or they didn't get the application right.
Or just got out of prison.
And because one nigga walked
coming
past
to the
me.
Stage. And he inmates.
So is it dudes or chicks?
It's dudes.
So the
it's
one dudes. Dude walked past me like review. He was Adonis. I said, so how long, much longer is the comedy show? Look here, Pet Bull.
Pet Bull?
Nigga,
that's his
like
name.
Nigga.
Not Pit Bull, but Pet Bull.
Pet Bull. Like Pet Milk.
He's a Pet Bull.
So yeah. So you there tonight?
Tonight.
Yes.
Hosting Empire. Or just going up?
I'm going to do a set, man.
Okay, cool.
Yeah,
cool.
Crack it.
Who's hosting?
I don't know.
It's that Empire thing with Kente.
Empire thing with Kente.
Kente's on it.
I talked to them about cutting my face off the flyer they posted, too.
Oh, Empire. What do you guys keep saying Empire?
That's what they call it.
Angel Gaines says it's called Empire, and it is Boogie B, Kente, another nigga, and Angel. I don't know him. I just know he got... Twist and Angel Gaines.
Mm. Yeah.
But they
so
were
what's the theme?
Like,
is it
never
improv?
Never heard of any of them.
Do they do improv?
No, they do. It's just a comedy show, and then Angel, she comes in with her sunglasses and her weed because she's supposed to be Cookie. And
okay.
And everybody.
Oh, so
it's like
theme.
A bit.
Yeah,
it's like a bit.
But they don't, they never address it. Like they never say, this is who I am.
I just saw the picture and everybody was like.
It's an Empire.
Picture like that.
Empire.
Yeah, I didn't get it, but okay.
Anyway, to get people out there.
Well, at least Kente's working. Okay.
Yeah, yes. Good for Kente.
Give me information.
Vanessa Graddick on everything, VanessaGraddick.
Dick at the end.
Mm. Always at the end.
Sorry, Ryan, you're supposed to be my friend.
Can you spell your name again?
No.
I'll spell it for you.
You're supposed to say emphasis on the dick.
Hilarious.
Graddick.
Okay.
Graddick in your map. Pam.
Right. Nikki Pam on everything. With Nikki Pam with 2 K's. And remember, we're going to be in Palm Springs July 21st to the 24th. Nice. Party in Palm Springs. Pips Party in PalmSprings.com. For a comedy show Thursday night. 70s show. I mean, 70s dance.
Who's on the comedy show, Speedy? You going?
Speedy? Is this thing?
It's mine.
Yeah.
What you trying to do?
I ain't trying to do nothing.
Because we do look, new people.
And you anyway. Know, I hate doing this with Rodney.
Because
he go, mean? He going to know Speedy, I'll do it. Then he'll call me back, hey, Speedy.
So not enough, man.
So I book Rodney for a show.
Oh God!
And he don't really give me the real
over?
Price. No.
No,
he never give me the real yeah, real we, price. Yeah. And he goes, "Speak, we, me and you cool, but
getting a little more. Than
I'm right? getting a little more. Than I said, well, Rodney, that's all I got. Maybe not, but look here,
it's
you
always
if
more
you can't
money.
Do five. I said, but Rodney, they don't have this. How much you getting? Really, nigga? You don't want to pull from
you're me. You're destroying the budget.
Yeah, yeah. You don't want to pull from you to get me? No, nigga, I don't.
You don't want to pull from you to get
I've
me.
I've never said that. I've never, ever said
hilarious.
That. I didn't
I know
that.
Speedy does put 2 on a 10.
Speaking of Speedy.
And then we got also.
Speaking of Speedy, we'll be at the J Spot on the 6th of May. It'll be our night. It won't be no strippers behind us. Don't worry about it. But we have tickets that we are selling. And mm-hmm. if you donate to the show on
either GoFundMe or PayPal.
Oh, nice.
And then you'll get a ticket. And if you don't live here, we'll give the ticket to a family member that may or a friend who lives here.
Yeah, if you guys want to give it to somebody who, you know.
Or someone like our crew, the Rollout Chat Room. If
is it a fundraiser?
You want us to finish?
it's a fundraiser for Rollout Radio.
Exactly. See, you see the banner leaning, nigga. We need pins and safety pins. And
we got stuff to buy.
Nigga, you see Ron here, nigga. Hey, he ain't gonna be here for long. We ain't
no engineer.
Mm-hmm. You have a turntable and a closer.
He's like making an appointment
we'll
to leave
go
now.
Go back to Speedy's iPad. Right.
Speedy's playing.
So, yeah, definitely, man. So, if you want to come to the show, we want to pack out that night, May 6th, at the J Spot.
Only $10?
Yeah, for the ticket.
That's great. That.
Well, it's $15 at the door, so you probably want to. Yeah. Pre-buy the ticket for $10. And then also on the 29th, we have an all-white. What's it?
50 Shades of Funny at the Comedy Union.
Right. DJ Ron's going to be there.
50 comedians?
No, just 50.
You know, Rodney. Rodney. Robbie Perone.
Oh, that's it's going to be nasty.
No more. He. Oh, you haven't talked
Christian
about
him?
Yes.
What? You know
he's
they always
he's born again he's Christian.
Yeah.
Robbie Perone.
Yes.
I said
Robbie used to say he was me to get women.
I know
this for a fact. He told me. He's like, dude, I'm sorry, but I fucked this
I've been
like
you several times.
She thought I was you.
What?
Rob was a.
He's
that
changed. Dude.
And matter of fact, he's not even hosting. I host. He just let me host so that, you know.
Yeah.
Get out. Good for him.
Yeah, Rodney.
So that, like Rob, I said, Robbie, Comedy Robbie. Union on the 29th, J Spot on the 6th, and Palm Springs on the 21st to the 24th.
Yeah, I'm just be real with you. I can't afford your Palm Springs. I'd love to have you there.
I know.
But I know you.
It's okay.
You know. Okay. You're not okay.
I'm not.
So don't ask about it.
Okay.
You was inquiring about something you know you know.
I apologize.
So
keep it easy.
I won't let it happen again.
Rodney.
Please don't do it no more, Rodney. Give your information, Rodney.
It's your boy, Rodney Perry. Rodney Perry on everything. My Instagram actually is Rodney Perry Live. I do all social media. I blab. Y'all blab?
Well, what the hell is blab?
You don't know about blab, son?
No.
Blab is like Periscope on steroids. Like, all of y'all could do blab. Y'all could do this show from your respective homes, and you could see all of y'all.
Yeah.
And you could have a chat room in it. Oh, yeah, it's very dope. It's very dope.
Oh, we might have to look into that.
Blab is very
dope. Hold on. Sky, the youngster of the group, can you get on the blab shit, please?
Blab is good.
All right, quick.
Really?
She got it.
Done. So blab is all of social media. I just think that's just
a lot
amazing.
Of dudes are calling you.
That's my son.
Whatever.
one guy. And so hit me up or don't. Don't follow me. That's really what I prefer.
And also, you guys, remember to follow DJ Ron C. So it's DJ Ron C 7 on all social media.
Yeah, if you need a DJ for your kid's birthday or for grown-up parties, he can do it.
Mm-hmm.
He can do it. Well, you know, people have kids having birthdays and DJ and all that shit. Go ahead, Pete.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
Portis.
She's on the phone.
From Chicago people. Are you on Blab, too? Is that what that is? Periscope. Oh, okay. You're supposed to talk or something.
No. She's scooping us.
Right, she's Periscope.
Oh, I knew that. Anyway, go ahead, Pete.
She's on the phone.
Wow, this is that bullshit. Anyway, thank you, Precious.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah, that was dope. And you little jeans on fire right there.
I know. I like that.
Coming out them motherfuckers. Who this like nigga is scaring the shit out of me? Who is this little nigga?
That's my son.
Oh!
Little Thug. Come here.
He was robbing.
Little Ronnie Thug. Come here, man.
I thought we was getting robbed.
We said.
Is that who y'all saw earlier?
Yes.
I was like, hey.
I am going through the
because he didn't give no smile or nothing. He just went. You know what I mean, nigga? Just keep coming in.
We said a light skinned nigga.
What's up? Hello.
What it do, man?
What's that?
I don't know what's happening. Music?
How y'all doing today?
All right.
Yeah, that's Lil Rodney.
Okay.
All right, Lil Rodney.
Okay.
All right,
Lil Rodney.
Okay.
Show is gone to shit.
23 years old.
Okay.
Yeah,
he's how old?
23.
Oh, wow.
My brother is, I have a younger brother. He always my little brother. He get mad. This is my little brother. Nigga, he 40.
I say younger now.
My little brother.
My little brother.
Are you the oldest too, right?
Doesn't he rap, sister. Rodney? Is this the son?
Yeah, he raps.
Oh, you want to spit some shit? I'm with it. All right, you got to take your headphones off, though.
Yeah, you got to
turn your radio off.
Turn your phone off.
I don't know what's happening.
Yeah, a lot
you
of color.
Well, you just need an instrumental or something?
Yeah, a little summer outfit. Okay. Some of this and some of that.
Get over there by your dad.
Come over here, babe.
On his right side.
Is that Precious?
Go on his right side.
Come on this side. Come on.
That's the other Precious. That's the other Precious.
Hey, Precious. Young Virgo in the building.
Wait a minute. Precious, you a Virgo?
Yes.
When's your birthday? What the fuck? I'm a Virgo. I know there's a reason I hated you.
Ah, damn.
All right, so what's your name, man?
Revenue Hefner.
Oh, okay.
Oh, this nigga have a nickname? Nigga, what's going on in your household? Show your love for Revenue Hector?
Hefner.
Revenue Hefner. Do you need a beat? You got some generic
Ron
beat?
Ron got him.
Lil Rodney wasn't good enough.
Yeah, I guess not. It must have been took.
Okay. We in the studio. What's the name of the studio right here?
It's on the wall.
Morris Media.
Okay. Morris Media. Wikipedia. Look a nigga up in the future, I'm beating ya. In every subject, get the hub check, color on the... What's next? Got the freestyle, we style on everything, and the niggas know that he wild. I'm with Rodney Perry. The other comedian so scary.
Rap about sandwiches.
Milk these niggas, man, they dairy. Sandwiches, I'm in the middle of a sandwich, hairy. Actually, not wax twat.
Talk about your jewels.
I said my sweater, jewels, I'm so cool. Clear my throat, I'm a fool. I don't even
show
know.
Your love.
Nah.
All right.
Give me another beat.
No.
I'll play it back from the top.
Rodney, I got about 7,000 jokes. You want to hear them all? All right, cool. Play what you want to hear. My nigga.
You got to play him some of this new shit this out.
This cool?
You can't
That's a hell of a beat right here.
First,
if he can, I think I can.
Fuck about the niggas.
Look. If money can make shit change, then I'm about to write a page that's gonna put me in the range. Drive me to my palace, pouring Henny up with Jane. Fuck, drowning out sorrow, I'm just toting up the game. No more piñata, beef enchilada. Bruce Chris Steakhouse, Hakuna Matata. They throwing coke parties at the Hotel Ramada, but I'd rather write some lines to cop some custom bimbala. Nobody knew my name, but I pop up like bitch Walla. Fruits of labor lately, making ladies treat me like a Walla. I'm a fucking pimp, dust my shoulders, pop my collar. I can show you how to make a stripper, give her last dollar. This is black entertainment. That's a bet. That's free promo. Yo, shit, I need a fucking check. I bust a rhyme, shawty. Let me see you break your neck. Getting ratchet, yelling, turn down for what they wear.
Rodney. Rodney. Get the headphone.
We gonna have Bible study after this.
You do know your son, cuz.
He taught him how to cut.
Okay, cool. No, he's talking. Hey, Dave, where your motherfucking ass at, huh?
Whoa, hey,
on the phone. Lil Rodney in the building, better known as
Rev Hef.
Rev in the Hef. Building.
Young Devonit.
What's your social media?
On Twitter at Rev Hef. Instagram at Devonitly DG, like definitely, but my name is Devin, so Devonitly DEVINITELY DG.
Mm-hmm.
And
nigga creative.
Yeah.
Devin at DVVVVV.
Rodney, how do you
with the
feel,
Devin?
How do you feel about your son?
I'm
how
the
do you
Devin.
Feel about your son getting in the entertainment business?
I mean, it's kind of a double-edged sword. Yeah, you know how hard it is as an entertainer. You know how difficult it is, and the amount of time you have to go without people knowing.
Yeah.
And so, and then music is even harder than what we do. Mm-hmm. So you
that's why he got all,
I'm Devonair with the DVVVs. He put the DVVs, Devonair, bitches. Let's go, daddy.
Bitches and daddy?
Daddy? Don't go together?
Hey, bitches and daddy? Fuck these bitches. Daddy, you ready to go?
But you right. But you be proud, just like if your son was an athlete, though. You be proud. You're like, oh, shit, yeah, you know. Good for you. Beautiful.
Yeah, he's doing something positive.
Yeah.
He scared the shit out of us. I just want you to know. Walking around the hall.
Nigga. Like, and you didn't see it. We was like, who's the little nigga just walking around? And then Pete, that's why Pete came out with no shoulders moving. She's like, mm-mm. We couldn't find her. So we had to send the light skinned brother.
Y'all put him out. He was outside.
Oh, you put him out?
Yeah.
We
didn't know this nigga.
Oh, wait a minute.
Nigga, Ron, see.
That's why you went to live with Ron said. Hey, little nigga.
Like, I got it.
I need to step out. I'm definite with the VVV. No. What on the other side of
the definite with the VVV. That's VVV. Kind of dope.
I'm half, nigga. Ask my daddy. Oh, that's my daddy.
They got to break that shit down.
That's
my daddy.
Who?
Yeah, idiot.
Roger Perry, my daddy. That's cool. That's dope. Y'all
speaking
hang out.
Speaking of sons, man, how your kids doing, man?
They all great. Jeez.
That's good stuff.
Yo, I got a granddaughter. They all great. Brooklyn.
Because I remember when me and one of your sons went to high school together, and I was like... I was like, man, your dad is cool.
Your daddy's cool.
That's a pretty good one. I like it. No, wheels is turning right now.
Rodney, how many kids do you have?
I have 6 children. Oh, it's my only boy. I got 5 girls.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. 6 kids, 5 girls.
And where does he fall in line?
He's 2. So it's 27, 23, 20, 15, 13, and 6.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So I will be raising.
So
children.
Do the other daddies come see those kids or?
Damn.
Let your daddy know I'm here.
Let your daddy know.
Like I used to go pick my son up. Brooklyn. I mean,
tell your daddy.
Justin and I wouldn't sit down to do house. I was like, yeah, tell Justin I'm here. And like, you have sit down? No, I'm cool. Seat,
come on, brother.
I don't want to sit down in your house, man.
Oh, damn.
Justin!
Damn.
Your son sit right there.
I'm cool, brother. Go on about your business. Now, Justin! You want to go to the mall and get some?
Get some?
All the kids looking at me like, Justin, go to get some. Yeah, we going to the mall. I'm cool. I don't need to sit down.
Justin, take 40 minutes.
40 minutes.
He ain't nowhere near ready.
Yeah, and I'm right in the middle of the motherfucking living room. Like, it's standing couches and shit. I'm standing. Ask me if I want something to drink.
You want
something I don't to drink from your house, brother.
Damn. God. Are you mad?
You know, it's dinner time.
I'm not drinking from your house, man.
I mean, but if you want.
I'm good. Justin!
Yeah, with this shit hit. Boy, I'm thirsty. Uh-oh, motherfucker. I hear you being parched, man. Why don't you
I'm just... cool, though. I'm good.
All right.
Yeah. And could you not ask me no more?
I'm not.
All right.
I'm not
asking you. Thank you. All right.
But if you want to sit down, you can.
I would sit down for a minute.
Legs start falling asleep.
But no, I would never sit in this house. Never ever do that.
Why? Did y'all have beef?
Y'all didn't have beef? That was just my get down.
What was the science behind that?
I didn't know. I just told myself when I go, because I had to go pick him up, and she got married.
With her no more.
She had got married.
Yeah.
And I had to go pick up Justin, and I just said, I ain't sitting in this nigga house. I just
Why?
Didn't want
to.
Pride
thing?
I don't know.
Who's raising your son?
Yeah.
Like, you only had Saturdays.
Damn.
That's hilarious. That's
yeah, that is funny.
Like, he really now, had your back.
But now I'm stepdad.
Y'all cool now?
I'm a stepdad.
You a stepdad now?
Yeah, I got 2 stepkids.
That's good for you, man.
Mother. No.
Mm-hmm. My stepdad was great. I mean, he was abusive to my mother, but he was great to us.
Oh, damn.
Man. Shit, you want to ease into that?
I mean,
he beat the shit out of my mom, but he cool to me. He like me.
Hell of a pancake. I mean, let me tell you something.
Oh, God.
Come breakfast time, he was like, you know
bitch, what? Rodney, come here. I love you.
She wants the pancakes. Yeah, you like that?
Oh, damn.
Oh, my God. That is so rough.
It's real life.
And then I didn't know, and I told the story that I was a stepson until later. I got 16. And then my mother revealed to me that. Yeah.
The guy you thought was your father was not your father.
Don Ray ain't your daddy. I was like, who? Don Ray now? We got the same name, dog. How the fuck that happened?
Wow. My dad, for namesake, Benjamin Perry, he's not my biological father.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because my mom fell in love with an old man. You know,
I know, because that name is old.
What, Rodney Perry?
Mm-hmm. Benjamin.
Ain't too many Benjamins coming out of the pipe.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. That was his name, but he knew my mom was pregnant, and he was like, you know what? I don't want this child to not have a name.
Same thing my dad did.
That was the honorable thing to do.
Yeah. Same thing my dad did. Because
they don't do that no more, though.
My mother swear she they ain't never even did it. It's like, it ain't no way he think you his kid.
My mom keeps it so real. Yeah, and when I think back, I gotta go pick on my mother after this, and I think back because she had like two kids when she wasn't married. And it's seven of us all together. And I went, Mom, you was out there a little bit. You was getting it in. I'm fucking a little bit. Mom, you
hilarious.
But that was she married twice more after that. And then
she got married though. They would get married.
Yeah.
You know, women nowadays don't get married.
And I told like the last dude he died, but you know, he was trying to be my friend. I was like, nigga, it's too late, nigga.
Really?
It's too late. I ain't got time. What are we gonna do? Father son walks? This nigga.
Nigga, first of all, he can't walk.
He can't. Oh. He had a stroke. He was.
Oh.
My mother took care of him.
Oh wow!
He had that bottom bed at the steps in the living room. Like soon as you walk in, hey,
you right here. My mom,
they ain't want to take you upstairs. The door. You can't go. They can't get this upstairs. Cool.
Ain't it a breeze here?
You want some water? Is my mama here?
She been gone. Your mama gone.
Can you give me something? No, I can't do nothing. But
it's her job. I messed around. Last time I gave you the wrong medicine, you was sick for 7 days.
I bought the wrong pan in. I ain't know that ain't the one you shit in, but
I brought the pee pan. I ain't know who knew.
Oh my God.
And I can't change it. That's not me. That ain't what I do.
What's not gonna happen?
We're not gonna do that.
That's what I don't wanna be. Ever at a point where people had to change me as an adult. You know, like, cause you know, somebody could have to take care of you, man.
He's not listening, but you haven't talked to Courtney.
I haven't. Courtney did correspond, and he is better.
He's doing better.
He did give us a shout out too on social media.
I thought he was in Cleveland. I was in Cleveland last weekend, he's in Seattle. I'm like, oh man.
So we talked for a very long time.
Okay.
And one of his things was why he hadn't been on stage because he has to use a crutch to get on, and he didn't want anybody to see him like that.
Oh wow.
And I made me think like again, and a young lady called in and asked why did I get married. And that was another reason too. I didn't want to be the old dude that my kids got to take it. And then, not that I got married so someone would take care of me, but at least to know that somebody cares about you. You know what I mean?
Somebody got your back.
Because at some point, we all going to be at a point in our life where somebody's going to have to do something for us. But you don't want nobody putting a pamper on you? Yeah. What I don't want to have is that's why I drink a lot of water, the stroke. Cause
you don't want the stroke face?
Yeah, really? I'm like okay looking now. Stroke face going.
You need all your face muscles.
Yeah, I need to look just like this to the end. Anything go bad right now, it's gonna be a hard sell. He's like, ooh, Speedy, leaking. Somebody get a napkin. Why can't my ear? Or if you gotta change me, that ain't new. I'm gone.
As a comedian, you ever almost killed somebody? Like made them laugh so hard?
Would you give them a stroke or something?
The only reason I asked that because I got a story.
Tell it.
So I met Tommy T's in
Oakland.
Pleasanton.
Oh. Yeah.
Right. So I'm on stage and we do the show. End of the show, they say, yo, Rod, some dude had a seizure. Oh. And I'm like, yo, is he okay? No, he was okay, but I was like, in my mind, I was like, it would have been kind of cool if he had died.
You know what?
Oh, they died laughing.
Really?
Because then you can, you for the rest, that's a credit. For the rest of your life, Rodney Perry kills motherfucker.
I ain't done with you.
Right.
So anyway, long story short, he didn't
killing
die.
People.
Yeah, strep throat.
He didn't die. He didn't die. So, but this is how powerful healthcare is. This is the healthcare thing I'm putting out here, okay? So.
Shout out to Obamacare.
I have it. So get this. So they you know, paramedics. I break one now. We got you know, a seizure. He looked like he's stable. Let's bring the ambulance around. They said ambulance.
Ambulance.
This motherfucker shook that motherfucker. Ah.
No.
He didn't want to.
Nah, I'm good.
Oh yeah, you don't want to get
the ambulance bill.
No.
He didn't want the bill.
I mean,
fuck it. The ambulance alone is $1,500.
I take the Uber.
No, put me in the trunk, nigga. I'm good. Just in the trunk.
In the
close.
Trunk.
I close. Dude, hospital, please.
I said this dude shook off a seizure.
Yeah.
In lieu of taking an ambulance. Right?
Yeah, $1,500.
Wow.
Yeah. That they bill you.
Subconscious, powerful.
Yeah, they bill you.
Absolutely.
To your house, to your location. You're trying to give us a hint?
I think both of these was for you.
No, he handed yours first. Your son gave you yours first.
Yeah, he did.
My dad tried to kiss me.
Bye, God.
Man.
Anyway, is it over?
No, Portis. She got to give him a ring. Okay.
And then Portis, you got to give Sean Ellis his
birthday
thing, too.
So we need a, don't chew on the
mic. Did you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, Ron, give me a...
something sexy.
I don't want to say it. You say it.
Something sexy.
It wasn't that came out, right?
Hey, I'm so uncomfortable. Sexy.
Maxwell or whoever.
Maxwell.
Maybe not Maxwell, because...
Oh, yeah, because of the... Oh,
yeah.
Right.
Yeah, your son was good.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Speedy.
At least that's what you told me when you wrote this. Please say my son was good.
Please say my son was good.
Don't put the camera on.
Please say my son was good.
Don't put the camera on.
And that we'll have him back. Mm.
All right, party. Well, so we have a birthday.
Birthday wishes.
Sexy shout out.
Oh, yeah.
I had to keep it low. So.
Gratic.
Okay.
Don't look at me. Don't look at me.
Yeah, she don't want nobody to look at her.
Gratic. Let it happen, right?
Don't touch me there.
Mm.
Even though it's your birthday.
It's your birthday, isn't it?
I want to wish a very sexy...
So sad.
Oh, my. I'm getting uncomfortable.
You giggling too much. I hate old giggling. Fuck off my birthday.
I want to wish a sexy, sexy, sexy birthday. Shout out to Shad Ellis. Happy birthday.
Mm. Wow.
All right.
Yeah, Sean.
Well, yeah, I was
got all them babies out of his pocket. No, they're on my leg. It's on my leg.
Y'all send me that tape. Can I rewind that?
I want to slow it down.
Turn the lights down.
I want to pamper me.
All right, y'all.
It is y'all in the roller.
We got to go.
We got to get out of here. I got to go pick my mama up.
You picking up moms today?
Yeah. She didn't call 7 times.
She doing good? Health?
Yeah, she good. She just forgets.
Oh, yeah. My mom is on oxygen.
I called her.
Oh, really?
She won't drink wine every day, though.
Mine's good for you.
Put it in the tube.
That's what she said.
We have a call.
Put it in the tube.
Okay, caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Yo, this is Sean Ellis.
What it do, Sean?
Oh, you enjoy that, Sean? Ooh.
I'm over here rolling. That was hilarious. Thanks, Paul. That was good. Thanks.
Oh, you are.
God bless, Shani.
For sure.
You call a nigga Shiny?
I give people nicknames all the time.
Happy birthday, Sean.
Felt good.
Anyway.
Guy cut him off.
Yeah, my mother has called me 7 times. Each time she went,
so you today you coming?
I said, Mama, I talked to you yesterday. Well, what time? You going to be at 3:30 or 3:35?
She got a boyfriend?
I slapped shit out of you.
Are you serious?
75. It's over. So,
no, it's not.
No, it's over. It's not.
If you want your mother to have a...
We're going
to
leave now. You are not going to coerce my mama into fucking somebody at 75.
That's what she want to know, if you coming over or not.
Oh. Truth be told.
Right.
Listen to the background. Find out now. I'm sick of him sneaking. I ain't going under bed no more, Mabel.
Mabel.
My mama name is Louise. Nigga.
Louise? I ain't going under bed no damn more. You need to tell him.
I ain't going under the bed no more.
We grown, Louise. Weezy. We grown, Weezy.
We grown.
You know
Weezy.
I got jokes.
I'm sick of your son.
Sick of your son.
Better than one. What is his name? He ain't even fast. Why they call him Speedy? Sick of that. I'm sick of him. I was under the bed 12 hours last time.
What's your mama name?
None of your business.
Ronnie, thanks Venice. For coming by.
Thank you so much.
Thanks,
Ron.
Anytime, Ron. Come on.
Thank you for having me at your studio and your show. All right. And Speedy and the letter N. And friends. No, thank you so much. I love you, Speedy. And thank you
for being
wonderful as always.
Till Monday, we'll be back here doing the damn thing. Don't forget, hit my man Ron C up.
Oh, every day?
No, Monday, Tuesday. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.
Oh, that's dope.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, love it. She wouldn't let us go every day. She said, yeah, you know,
people actually pay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Nada.
What in the fuck? Ron C, 7 on everything. Make sure you hit him up. Take us home on the Freaky Friday, bruh.
Ron C.
We out.
All right.